young Force user girl who made the deal with him, like, if I win, then you have to let us leave. And if you win, then we'll surrender. Keel kicked her ass, obviously. She had no idea what she was doing. And then she was, they were literally in the process of surrendering when Satan showed up to micromanage our performance on the planet. Literally was like trying to enslave the people that were in the middle of surrendering already. So
and I had a really big problem with that.
Obviously. Yeah. Z has a problem with that. And then this dumb Jedi girl, which I don't blame her for doing what she did, decided she was going to try to protect her people, and Keel and I couldn't grab her quite fast enough to stop her from trying to attack Satan, and Satan shot her in the head, because Satan's also not above killing children. And then Satan left, and I'm echoing really bad from your mic.
You're very crispy.
I was going to say, is it just me?
Nope.
Like, what do you mean crispy?
You're staticky.
What do you mean crispy?
Yeah.
You look, it's like if Crunch Bars could talk.
Mm-hmm. I love Crunch Bars. Hold on.
So true.
Is that better?
Yeah. So okay. Far?
Yeah.
Then Satan shot her in the head and was basically like, I don't deal with people who don't follow orders or whatever. Whatever. He's a dick. He left. Keel did something that none of us know how to do. Brought her back from the dead.
Hi.
Super, super light side power. And then we snuck her onto our ship and immediately got yelled at by Avo. But then Avo was like, fine, I'm going to heal her, but I know nothing about this. And that was basically where we left off.
I know nothing about this play's immediate accomplice.
Yep. And you also all got a bunch of interesting upgrades, items, and so on, depending mm-hmm. on everything.
Ah, yes.
Some people got some bullshit items. However, Z didn't get anything. Instead, his droid got something, which is a railgun.
Very excited about that.
Use Dizzy, goddammit.
I'm going to now. Don't you worry about that.
All right. So we will go ahead and open up. I will say at this point, about 4 days have passed. If you wanted to try and keep the Cathar girl sleeping still, I will allow you to make one check for it, but keep in mind it's going to get harder the more you do it.
I'm fine with her waking up. I think we just wanted to do it for like a couple of days. So,
is our ship still parked on the dreadnought?
Your ship is not parked. Like, because before you were docked on like the side of the dreadnought near one of the airlocks, you have now been brought into the hangar bay. Like, your ship is fully docked.
Yeah. Okay.
But yeah, you are on the dreadnought as of the moment. No, nothing coming out. Oh, you're using your own thing. Okay. But yeah, a couple of days have passed. Probably sometime in the late morning. Avo would call for the party and basically just say, guys, she's waking up. You might want to be here for this.
I'm going to be there for that.
Okay.
I walk in behind all of obvious. I let Raiko and Keel kind of take the lead on this, but I'm very curious.
And we're all going to agree that ACOG would give zero fucks.
Yeah.
He's probably not even in the room.
Dude, he's not even in the room. He's just he's in his room sleeping off a drunken stupor. He's fine.
With a couple bottles next on his nightstand.
Exactly. But yeah, slowly, as you guys get in, she starts to open her eyes and shake herself awake. And
Raiko's getting advantage on charisma checks, by the way.
Okay, cool. However, at this point, Connor, would you like to take over?
Spicy.
Sus?
You are silent.
I'm sorry.
That's anyway. His way to say no.
I can hear him talking, and then it's quiet.
Yeah, no.
Alright, but take over.
And just confirm, they just walked in?
They just walked in a moment ago as she's waking up.
So, the Cathar child just like, I imagine it's probably been in a daze for a while, and just, like, she looks and is like, what? Oh, God. She looks like she has a racking headache. Oh.
Can't imagine why.
Good morning.
She locks with these, like, and she almost, like, hits, like, get back! And she just, like, is she restrained at all?
No. She does, however, have a slave collar on.
What? No, we wouldn't have put that on her.
Avo put it on her.
I think we have to.
Avo put it on her in order to make it seem like she's actually not free.
Her not being a slave is more weird.
Is it fun- yeah. Is it functioning?
Yeah.
Like,
It is functional, however, Avo has the control.
Okay.
Well, she falls out of her bed and tries to, like, just backpedal and just gets into a corner. It's like, get back! And she's looking for a weapon.
Raiko's gonna, like, hold her hands up and be like, all right, I understand. This is a startling thing to wake up to. For the record, I'm very sorry for what happened. That was not our intention.
What? She rubs her head. And I feel like there's a scar.
Yeah.
There is absolutely a blaster scar.
What? Do I still have her saber?
Do you have her saber?
I thought I took it initially.
You did take it. I don't know if you still kept it.
Yeah, I have it.
Before you panic, please let me explain a couple things.
I was shot?
Yes.
I was...
And the one that you're yelling at to get away from you literally saved your life. So, we're trying to help. Also, I just want to let you know that you have a collar on. That is so that you don't draw suspicion because we snuck you onto our ship.
Wait. You... Oh, my...
It is literally for your safety because it will raise more questions if you don't have one on.
Oh, hold on. What happened to Cathar? What happened to my family? What happened?
Know what happened, Cathar?
Yeah, they all got turned into warriors for the Mandalorian people.
Maybe a little softer approach would be better right now?
Wait. Warriors? You were making them all slaves. You were making... She grabs her collar. You're making me a slave!
No! I just explained that is solely to not raise suspicions because... you onto our ship after our boss tried to execute you. I mean, kind of succeeded, but not really.
She absolutely succeeded.
Yeah, that one also saved your life. We're trying to help. I realize we're the bad guys in your eyes, but not all of us are bad guys, if that makes sense.
We're bad guys, but we're not.
We're not bad guys. I'm just gonna roll a persuasion right now to try and chill her out a little.
I'm gonna be honest with you, roll that at disadvantage.
So it's a straight roll.
Disadvantage.
It will be a straight roll because of his ability.
So 27.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, she takes a few deep breaths. Alright. Say I believe you. What happens next?
We're trying to sort that out. Ideally, if you work for us, that will be the safest place for you to be right now.
Could I leave? Would you let me go?
I wouldn't. But you could.
I don't think that would work out very well for you.
Avo would just smile, like, be kind of like, weary smile and just go, well, I mean, you could leave. You won't get very far.
ACOG said he had some connections that could make it work.
I think she's saying she won't get very far because aren't we in space right now?
that.
Yeah, you won't get far out the airlock.
Yeah, you won't get very far out the airlock, and also the only other way outside of the ship is through the dreadnought, which is full of Mandalorians, which would probably end poorly.
Correct.
Yeah.
I have a question for you, though.
All right.
And he'll, like... Cause is she still, on, like, on the floor in the corner?
Yeah, she's crunched up against the corner, probably her back to another bed. And she's still very much on high alert.
So he'll squat down. He won't even be, like, near her. He'll be, like, 20, 30 feet away. He'll just squat down, military kneel style. Do you still care about your people and your family?
Of course. Of course I do.
Good. I thought that would be the answer. Do you want to help them?
She nods slowly.
Then do you agree with me that being alive to be able to do that is the best case scenario?
Slowly nods.
Good. I think we see eye to eye. So, you being alive is a good thing. You leaving, not working with us, kind of contradicts that whole idea. You lunging out at our boss, that we all don't really like a whole lot, also not working towards, you know, you staying alive, right?
He was murdering my people.
Oh, yeah, no.
You murdered my people.
Kinda. I mean, we could talk about that later.
I didn't murder anyone.
Incorrect. You murdered a couple people.
I'm one.
At least two.
Well, had it coming.
To be fair, it's also part kind of our job, and you might end up doing some things you won't like, but you'll be alive to do it. I can promise you that much.
Katie tried to do Remember No Russians. Did not work. Call of Duty, there's an episode where you do where it's just a bunch of dudes with machine guns in an elevator. And the first thing he says is, "Remember, no Russians." And they just mow down an airport.
Yep. Modern Warfare 2.
The fucked up scene.
Yeah, that was a fucking hard mission.
Yeah, I don't play COD, so.
Yep.
Yeah, no, but that was a mission that just...
That was controversial.
Into the psyche.
Yep.
Yeah.
It was what we did on last week, but like 100 times worse.
So much worse.
Wonderful. Anyway, we're still kneeling like next to me or like in front of her.
He's like 20 feet back. So he's like halfway through the medical bay if she's on like the end of it.
Ryko's gonna like walk over and nudge Gil and put her hand out for the kid's lightsaber.
I was getting to that, but he'll hand it to you.
Okay, fine. Okay, well, I mean, if you want to get to it, have be my guest.
Does she say anything to what he said?
She just looks at you and is just, "So you want me to fight for you?" So
with us would be a better terminology.
And we would be slaughtering more people like you did on Cathar?
Ideally, no.
Necessarily.
Have we been told what our jobs are for the future? Have we been briefed on that yet?
Not technically yet.
At this point, I have not.
Ryan has not. You two.
What about Ryko and Keel?
You two probably would have because yours has a much more impact than the others so far.
So our next mission is, I'm going to tell her this, our next mission, me and Keel anyway, we're going to be basically going on supply run. Does that make sense? Not a lot of murder on supply runs, no.
It's going to be real boring.
Can you give me a deception check, please?
Sure! I get to roll that in advance. 24.
Fair enough.
Hold on.
Do you want Defiant just for funsies?
Sure.
Yeah.
I'm not technically lying. We're going on supply runs. I'm just not giving her any.
We're just resupplying on other people's stuff. It's fine.
We're resupplying that was the inside by just stealing from other person. People.
I'm aware, and she believes it, but she doesn't want to believe it.
It's more along the lines
of technically lying, and also Ryko and Keel don't exactly know all the details yet either.
correct, but still.
You still obviously know something bad's gonna happen,
so I'll let it. For now, continue.
And I'm sorry, your name was Keel? Pointing, well, at Keel.
Yep.
And you are.
I'm Raiko.
Z. And he, like, thumbs to Z at the back of the room.
Stop. Yeah.
Avo?
I guess.
Hello.
We're here. Oh, you changed Keel's art.
I did.
Oh, no. It's like Devil May Cry now.
I know.
I like that art. I've seen it already, but I like it.
In 4 months, he will have a haircut. Right now, he still looks like old him.
Yeah, I guess I should.
And...
Oh, what? Hey, and Daito. He points past Z.
Yeah.
He's a finger wave.
They're cool.
Hey.
You have quite a group. You're getting the impression she probably hasn't met that many aliens.
Well, you're meeting a bunch now.
True. Who taught you how to use the Force and the lightsaber?
An old man back home. Apparently, he had a falling out with the Jedi. Came home to spend his twilight years.
Hmm. I've heard a lot of that recently.
Sounds like my old master. Yeah, literally, same situation with my master.
Kill looks up at Raiko and he's like, do Jedis just, like, not stay Jedis for forever? Because that's most of the stories that I've heard recently.
I'm gonna be real honest, that's most of my experience with them, but I don't think that is a normal thing.
I do not know.
The old man, he wasn't too open about his relationship with the Jedi.
That's okay.
Kavar?
Honestly, I used to be a part of the Sith, so don't worry about it.
She just...
What?
She
Did
doesn't...
I say the race wrong?
What's Kavar. A Sith?
Yeah, so Kavar.
You're fine.
Oh, don't worry about that right now. It's not a big deal.
No, I want to know what a Sith is.
They're like... They
it's the opposite of a Jedi.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, that explains a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So you're an asshole, then.
Used to be.
The laughs.
She kind of definitely gives you a very incredulous
look. Raiko's like rubbing her temples like, no, he's not an asshole.
Oh, he's
made a lot of progress.
I mean, to be fair, I'm also the one that brought you back to life, if that means anything. Sith don't really do that. Well, not that way.
I'm more of a Jedi than he is, if you could call it that, I guess. And I don't even know how to do that, so...
I don't know what you did, but I don't know...
To be honest, I'm still trying to figure it out myself.
Raiko's gonna nudge Keel again to give her saber back.
So, you know, like, I will hold it out just in front of me. So I'm still, like, 15, 20 feet away. I will make a deal with you. You work for us, or with us, or whatever... terminology you want to use. I promise you one thing. Whatever happens, whatever things this group does, we're going to make sure that people like you live. They'll look back at like Z and Daito, like, right?
He puts his hands up, he's like, fine with me.
Daito leans over and he's like, exactly.
We get to choose exactly how we work. We don't get to choose the job all the time, but we get to make it what we want it to.
Do you work for that man who... Was that man who shot me, was he the one ordering you?
Yeah. He's one of our... bosses.
Yeah, he's, to be fair, he's newly appointed as the person we report to, and I already don't like him, so you're not alone in that.
We have
he's a newly hired supervisor.
I don't intend for him to be around for long. Not that I'm gonna kill him, I just don't want to work for him. He sucks.
She thinks for a good bit. definitely openly considering the offer.
And to be fair, when our time under his reign is over, we'll probably just let you go. Like, I don't really care, but it's not safe for you right now, and I don't want you to die again, so...
Yeah, come, especially come work with us. Put our asses on the line. You want here?
But if I work with you, would I... And she kind of looks at the, like, looks at your, like, her lightsaber in your hand and looks at your, like, your lightsaber, the one that kind of gave off that massive sickly glow.
Hmm?
Would I have to murder people? But innocents?
Or could I don't refuse? Think so.
The goal of this crusade is not to murder innocent people.
Then what is it? Why do you fight? Why are you even working for these people?
Mandalore wants to unite the galaxy and then reclaim his homeworld of Coruscant.
So we are working for Mandalore to reunite the galaxy as a whole. He wants homeworld. We're all kind of working for him for different reasons. Personal stuff mostly. I guess I could go.
She looks down at it and just. If I want to eventually be able to go back home. When you're able, there's ever an opportunity, I would like to be able to go home. I'd like to see the people, and I want to make sure that the people I tried to protect, what happened to them.
I think that's a good goal.
I just want to live in peace.
Do we know if their people will be released after the crusade is done? Or if that's more of a permanent status?
I think that's probably a you don't know yet.
Yeah, that's a you're not entirely sure yet. You are muted. Well, nothing's coming out.
Dumb broke it. Hey, Aaron.
Hey.
But she was basically saying you guys don't know how long the crusade's going to last yet. Either,
also that.
So.
Well, I can't tell you how long it'll be or how long it'll take.
No.
But I'll do my darndest.
Sim, I feel like this is kind of the persuasion check.
Nope. And also,
although
the answer
I would say
is...
this is probably at advantage with both Ryko and Kiel helping each other.
I would say, yeah. One of you may roll persuasion at advantage.
Her.
You should already have advantage. What does it give?
Double advantage.
If I roll persuasion, she contests it with insight. If she rolls lower than me, she's charmed by me.
Okay.
I don't know if I use that though, because I feel like that's kind of like.
That's a little invasive, but, you know. Let's see.
Do you want me to roll
honestly,
that same roll against him?
Yes, I will need an insight check.
Alright, whisper it to you, or just roll it open?
No.
Open or private?
This will be open.
Can you hear me now?
No.
Nope.
Oh!
Oh, man.
We can't
yes,
because
this is an opposed check. This is an opposed check, so yes.
I have a chance. I you had a not. Chance.
You do not.
She has a plus 13. No, you don't.
Yeah. I mean, no, she don't. If she rolled below average, I might have. She had to roll seven.
She had to roll a seven.
She had to roll two sevens.
Is not impossible.
Yeah, that's fair. But she slowly gets up. I will.
No.
Okay,
Sorry.
Before she even finishes her sentence, I'll toss her her saber.
I didn't say anything.
No?
Just shrug.
What?
I was going to look at you.
Are you in, like, with me being around, are you in danger? Like...
Maybe just a little bit.
Ava's gonna like look at the party after you toss the lightsaber and then hear the question of are you in danger, and he's just gonna look at Keel and go, now we are.
I just like cock an eyebrow at her, just shake my head.
She like, I assume she's probably in like the equivalent of like probably like a gown for like medical treatments and whatnot.
Yeah, probably.
I'm not sure how much I'll be of use.
Well, we're going to change that, actually.
We are?
Well, I am.
Okay, what's the plan, then?
Yeah, she shares that same sentiment.
Just, like, points at her. We got some training to do, you and I.
Oh, let's get down to business.
Woo! Achievement unlocked. Apprentice.
Oh God. No.
Oh no! I need that. I need the Xbox 360 sound effect. Bloop bloop.
One.
Alright,
Katie.
You're very impulsive. You're smart. You got a lot of drive. You got good goals. I can work with that.
I want to survive and save my people.
Hun, I am just the person you want to talk to about this.
am I in danger? And on like a more cosmic level.
The shrug.
I was like, oh boy.
All right.
Now there are two of them!
Amazing.
By the end of this, just a fucking Sith juggernaut. Oh god.
It's just gonna be, what is it? Buff Sayori?
Buff Sayori?
It's just a buff Cathar. Big cat.
Oh my god! That is a cursed image. That is a fucking cursed image.
Did you look up Buff Sayori?
Yes. Hold on. I'm going to have to share this eye cancer.
It's so good. It's so good.
That is eye cancer.
That is... I let me go get the bleach, boys.
Also, it makes it even better that there are no legs.
Yes.
It's just the bottom. Oh god. Okay. Well, Avo's going to stare at you with concern, but she's gonna put her hands up in the air and go, you know what? That's fine. That's fine. I'm gonna go over here. You do whatever.
She's like, this is par for the course, honestly.
Does she pull out a flask?
Connor.
I need
Connor.
A drink.
Yes. No.
She has a bottle.
She is a doctor.
She pulls out a syringe.
Classy.
She pulls out Absorbing Junior. That's what she pulls out.
Oh my god.
Slaps a patch on her arm, calls it a day.
She just injects some Dilaudid straight into the vein, and she's out for the rest of the day. Doesn't give a fuck anymore. No, but she's just gonna be like, you know what? You guys do whatever. I'm gonna keep doing what I was doing before you guys walked in.
So nothing?
No, smartass. Reading the stuff that you guys brought.
You've been doing that for 3 days?
I've almost deciphered it, I think.
Okay. What have you got so far? I'm curious.
Yeah.
Well, and she'll, like, pull it up on the terminal and then project it onto the wall. And you see the exact same star map as you did before.
Yep.
Except it's 2D instead of 3D. And she goes, so the language that it's written in, I'm going to be honest with you, I can't find anything about it. But with enough effort, with some help from Pascal and actually Dizzy here, there, and everywhere, we found some...
Nope.
Very, very only, quietly.
Only through Cypher's headset.
Yeah.
I heard it, but it was really quiet.
I'm not seeing the thing pop.
She's like gonna yell at it, and it's gonna work just fine.
Yeah, and then we're gonna all get our ears blasted.
Exactly.
Or screams into her mic.
Do we have a wired headset that she could try to switch to? I mean, I brought my good one back to work with me, so I don't got that.
Hello?
Hey!
Oh, there you go! Hey.
God, I was about to get so fucking mad. I, like, restarted my whole computer.
Also, where the fuck did the rim tap?
There's
come
a
from?
Soundboard on Discord now.
Shut
I'm
up,
sorry. What?
Where?
Where?
Yeah.
No way.
Mitch, where?
Oh no.
No. You gotta show me this because if I can add sounds on here, I'm gonna.
It's you have to do it to the here. Server. But yeah. Yeah, I'm loud.
Oh god.
Who's playing that?
That's right.
Wow, what the frick?
That was loud as hell.
That was loud.
I have activities, share screen, and that's it.
It's next to start an activity.
I have to restart my Discord for it to pop up. He has to restart his Discord. It's not on his yet. Mine just updated.
You can update it from your computer. Yo, I'll be right back. Hold on.
Quack.
Can you guys see? I can't hear the thing I'm clicking on.
Oh no! Yes, watch up.
There's a few second delay. Okay, I understand.
Yeah. Oh,
this is
gonna
be
here.
Awesome.
What? I know. I'm already thinking about it.
This is gonna be great.
God, it's over.
Oh no!
Oh, I can mute soundboard privileges if you abuse it. By the way,
that's fine.
Keep that in mind.
I need privileges so I can act so I can add sounds for later. Anyway,
okay. Did she join us? Because I missed like all of that.
Yes.
Yeah.
Tentatively.
Yes.
It's like a probably
in this chat. What the fuck is that?
Oh, because Connor was saying because Keel basically adopted her as an apprentice, and Connor was basically saying that by the end of the game she's going to be a Sith juggernaut, so it's just going to be buff Sayori, but as the
damn, I was going to offer to train her.
I mean, we'll both do it, obviously.
I
but...
want a
Listen,
one.
You just adopted a cat. You just
yeah.
Sith murder cat.
You're in your next step as a couple! Hooray!
Yeah.
You're evolving.
You're evolving?
Look, you guys are already on the path of getting married. You adopted your first slave. Congratulations.
Star Wars yeah. Days of Rise continues.
I want to point out, I don't think there's any... Like, she's not able to hide the fact that she is incredibly hesitant and uncomfortable with the situation.
Oh, by far.
I mean,
to be fair, Ryko felt like that when she first joined also. She'll adapt.
I mean, in fairness, she woke up with a slave collar after being shot in the head and being told, congratulations, welcome to the army.
I did explain the slave collar to her. It's not that we wanted to put it on
and
her.
And I explained the being
so
shot in the
trouble.
Head.
Really a flesh wound? Walk it off.
It's just a flesh wound. Daito would know all about that.
Absolutely.
Oh, good lord. Okay, so... Oh, yes, that's right. Now that Katie's back. Ava was explaining what she found.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
So she... Now, let me ask you a question. did you guys explain to her the words that Ryko heard in her brain? Remember those words that I told you about? Did you ever tell Avo about that?
Probably I would have, I'm sure.
I don't even remember what she said.
I knew she was like fucking excited about all this shit. I probably would have given her all the information we had.
Fair enough. But yeah, so she is sitting there and she's saying that the droids in her eventually found patterns on the words that we could see, or the hieroglyphics, whatever they are. Some of them were very similar, some of them not so much. But we think the word builder is in most of them. So that's a good start, I think.
Builder?
But 3 days. Yeah.
Okay.
So whoever made this star map definitely considered themselves to be builders of something or some kind.
Okay.
I'm not sure. I have to do some more research. It's kind of hard to do when I don't have a lot of reference material. If you guys could find another one, I might be able to do some more.
Okay, we'll just get right on that, Avo.
I was just about to say that.
We weren't even looking for this and we found it.
Find the last one? Like, we just happened upon it.
It was an accident, so...
Of course, I know that. But, I mean, if we could, perhaps... find another one, I might be able to decipher more of it.
You know, I was gonna ask for her name, and I totally we moved on from that.
The Cathar raises her hand, patiently waiting.
Speak.
Hi.
I'm sorry. What's this about a star map? What happened? I'm sorry.
The puzzle we found.
You don't have to raise your hand to talk. You can just talk.
Okay.
Come here. But, like gestures.
Come here.
Just very cautiously giving you a side eye. Just walking forward slowly.
Points. Star map.
Okay.
Found it. No idea what it does. Ancient language. You're caught up.
Oh. You're caught up. The funny part is you're not wrong.
So you have no idea what it is? Or I know it's a Stvarn map. Yes, I know.
We're hoping to find that information out.
You call it a Stvarn map? Or a star map?
It is a star map.
I'm going to call it Stvarn map.
Stvarn map.
Stvarn.
It's that cat tongue. Can't pronounce the tuz.
Yeah. Sorry. Anyway. Okay. Okay.
You know, to be fair, I know you guys don't like him, but if we did tell Cassis about it, we might get more resources to put into this.
Or he'll just take it away from us and we'll never see it ever again.
Also that.
That is also a possibility.
That's a coin flip that I don't like our odds on that coin flip.
Yeah, considering the amount of evil that was pumping out of this thing, having it in someone like Cassis's hands is not for the best.
Can we tell Mandalore about it?
I'm going to be honest, Cassis isn't evil. He's just very...
immoral.
Pragmatic.
Sure. The Cathar raises her hand again.
Stop.
Yes, you don't have to raise your hand. What is it?
Are you sure he isn't evil? He seemed very evil to me.
He has his moments, but so does everybody else.
That was a lot. That was a very big moment.
Mm-hmm. I mean,
it was.
I get why he killed you. I mean, he needed to set an example for the rest of them so that they didn't do anything stupid. She, like, looks at her.
That is, of course, not calling you stupid, just that it was probably not a good decision to attack him like that.
We tried to stop you.
Did so that stop you?
Shit didn't happen. Well, I mean, not
quick
enough.
Yeah.
He was enslaving my people. He enslaved my people. Just
I get it.
Oh no, I understand.
You did the right thing, just not at the right moment.
Just got you killed.
All about
right thing at the wrong time.
Huh.
Good intentions, okay. Bad execution.
And the road to hell is paved with good intentions.
Execution of him?
I mean...
I'm not.
Keel just shrugs.
What was the question?
She wants us to kill him.
No, she's going to teach me good execution of him. She wants to kill him. I feel like there's a line, though, for that.
I was just going to say, get in line, sweetheart.
Yeah, for real.
The line's about 10,000 leagues deep, I'm going to be honest with you.
Dude, even Thrag said he was an ass.
Well, to be fair, Thrag doesn't like him because of other reasons.
Oh, really?
Was Thrag a zealot at one point?
No, I doubt it. There's no fucking way.
No. He's born and bred.
Okay. All right. Was he denied zealotry? Salty about it?
I'm going to go with no.
Okay. I'm going to keep guessing.
Okay, you can keep guessing. Okay. That's a question for him. I'm going to be honest with you.
All right.
I just know that...
Yeah, I'm going to ask him.
He's got a bit of a chip on his shoulder on that.
Sure. Also, points at Cathartric. What's your name?
I'm Dahaza. Dahaza Pishami.
I'm sorry, you're going to have to spell that.
I already have it spelled out there.
He already did.
Haza.
Dahaza.
Alright, do I get a room? Or am I staying here? What's the plan?
Do we have extra rooms on the ship?
We don't have rooms upstairs.
We have a lot of extra rooms.
You'll probably have to stay with the crew downstairs, but that's fine. Or actually, the crew... The ship isn't operable, so we don't have a crew, per se. They're not sleeping on the ship, are they?
They do. You have a crew quarters below the main deck.
Right. But if we're docked on the Dreadnought, they're probably not sleeping on the ship and sleeping on the Dreadnought instead?
Some of them will, because the Dreadnought has its own crew and quarters, so they will probably mostly stay on the ship. Some of them will get off.
Otherwise, they'd have to, like, move all their shit.
Avo will chime in and go... I might have a solution to that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh?
Well, they're not that comfortable, but the medical beds are free. True. And if you stay in here and help me, that makes it seem a little bit less suspicious.
True.
That works for me.
Flying under this radar for sure.
Okay, if that's... She looks at Keel and Raiko. That's all right with you two.
Yeah.
That's a great idea.
I can teach you some force healing if you don't know how. That might come in handy in here.
I'm not too good in using the force.
And that's where the training comes in.
Yeah, we'll help you learn.
It's gonna be fun.
All right.
It's gonna be a good time.
Sounds like we're gonna be on these next missions for a while, so we got plenty of time.
All right.
Any questions?
Okay.
I'm certain I'm going to have a lot more later on, but...
Cool.
Right now,
we're usually around.
Is there a way I can just... rest? And have a...
I mean, you're almost fully healed. Like, tomorrow you'll be good.
Yeah, but, like, mentally exhaustion, you know?
Z chimes in after her, is like, she did just learn quite a bit in short amount of time.
It's been a lot.
But very well, that shouldn't be a problem. Pascal, could you please get them a blanket? And you just, like, see around the corner a big-ass battle droid, like, poke its upper torso in and then put up a thumbs up.
I like
that. Oh, probably some clothes, too.
Yes, actually.
I probably have some she can have.
You have so many clothes.
We should have some spares. That shouldn't be a problem.
You understand, Raiko has closets.
I do not.
Yeah, question.
Closets.
Yeah, I just have a question about that. Is that what happened to the other barracks room?
No. Keel, shut up!
Keel leaves, probably.
Marco just stares at the door like, are you fucking kidding me right now? No, that's not what happened to the other barracks room.
Deception!
It's the secret barracks room no one knows is a barracks room?
I feel like Raiko is now the princess from Spaceballs.
It's the fourth barracks room that no one sleeps in. It's just all of Raiko's shit.
It's a walk-in closet. It's a very large walk-in closet.
Look, man, disguises take up a lot of space. I'm not saying that in character, for the record.
Oh my god. Alright. So for the time being, Shiel will stay with Avo and get some rest. Anything you guys would like to do. I will tell you this. There is a marketplace on the Dreadnought.
Oh man, that would have been nice.
I mean, I'll look.
Yeah,
you might as well check it out.
Sure.
Keel still doesn't know anything that he would want to buy.
Facts. Now, does Tanner know things that he would want to buy?
No.
Well, that sucks.
Oh, look.
No, there's one thing I want.
Okay.
Is it just general items, or are there base, like, whatever the lowest...
So, this is Cassus's Dreadnought. There is a full requisitions office on this Dreadnought, and it is part of a fleet. So, if it's not on this ship, it's likely on another one.
Okay.
Does this
there
affect,
are...
Are we limited by use of the black card, like the within reasons type thing?
So the black card is only for general items.
Got
However,
it.
You guys, I forgot to mention this last session, you guys were paid 15,000 credits each.
Bruh.
Hey, yo?
You said 1,500?
15,000.
15,000?
You guys conquered a planet.
Dude, I have almost 20,000 credits now.
To be honest,
I'm at almost
70. In that shit.
I'm over 20.
I
want to
point out, you guys are basically commandos.
Yeah, you guys are getting paid very well for your work. He threw in it was only going to be 10, but he threw in an extra 5 because you survived the artillery.
Gee, thanks.
Hazard pay.
I mean,
hazard pay.
I'd rather get paid 10,000 and not get bombed from space again.
Well, I will tell you this, there are some enhanced items on the ship that you can potentially procure.
How much is a standard?
That's an interesting question. Let me pull up the chart.
And how much is a other tier up? I think standard is the cheapest.
I want to say standard is the cheapest. Then it's premium, prototype, advanced. It's basically... Let me see here. There was a chart, but I can't remember where it was for how much certain things cost. I'll figure it out.
Sure,
don't
sure,
worry
sure.
About it. But basically, some of the enhanced items, they're all going to vary based on like what they do and how much they all, like how rare they are. So, for instance, if you wanted to find an advanced item that causes you to bonus action turn invisible, that's going to be a lot more expensive than, you know, a standard stealth field generator. I don't know if that's actually an item, just giving you an example. Where did you go? I'm so sad. I cannot find this chart.
I can get great martial weapon.
What now?
I'm looking at my martial vibro weapons that have the finesse property, and there's some good ones.
But are you trained in it? As an operative, you're kind of limited.
Yeah, you are very limited in items that you can bring.
Well, I will look into that in session.
Okay. Then, let's see here. So, for a common rarity item, so a standard item,
mm-hmm.
It's going to be about, on average, about 1,500 credits.
Mm-hmm.
They're not super expensive, but they have their drawbacks. Anything the next level up is about 5 to 6,000.
Mm-hmm.
the next level up is going to start exceeding the 10 grand rule. Oh, did you find the thing? Did you find the chart?
I found the thing. It's go to that page I linked you, and it's like halfway down.
And it's standard, premium, then prototype, then advanced?
Yes. Cool. Ah, here we go. I was actually pretty close.
Yeah, you're really close. But the scaling's a lot and more intense.
The scaling's a lot more intense. So a standard rarity item is anywhere from 0 to about 1,500. Premium can go up to about 5,000. Prototypes go up to about 25,000.
Cool.
So at the moment, you're currently limited to prototypes, maybe advanced if you haggle hell well enough.
Oh, wait. Advanced was 20?
Advanced is 20, starts at 25,000 and goes up to 100,000. Okay. Prototype, you guys have enough to hit the max range of it. So if there is any items you are looking for, please let me know.
Yo?
Yo.
How much is prototype?
20? Prototype can go all the way up to 25,000.
Where does it start?
5.
What are item modifiers?
Item modifiers?
Augment.
Okay, so... Oh, you're looking at a modification. So you need to get a chassis of that item first, and then you can slot these modifications in to make the item more powerful.
What's your chassis?
However, they have their own. They have their own thing on there.
Every chassis has its own
interject. Just to interject a little bit, I feel like the Mandalorians probably won't have much in the way of like Jedi equipment, but more kind of leaning into the armory. But that's ultimately your call, Sim.
He's not wrong. I was gonna say that anyway. Relax.
Okay.
But yes, chassis, anything physically combat, like weapons, armor, and so on, they will have multiple items. If you have force-related items, those are going to be a little bit of a specialty, may take some time to procure, but is not an impossibility. So if you guys want to take a couple minutes to look at some potential items, let me know if you want to purchase them.
Connor, did you see my message that I sent you?
Can I take a look at that? Can you click on it?
It's force stuff, so they probably won't have it. But...
They will likely not have it, but you can ask them to get it for you, and we will see where it goes.
Sure.
They did have the Cape of the Orator, so it's not an impossibility.
I feel like that was procured for ACOG, though.
Well, it was not. It was a more standardized item.
Yeah, also, that's not, like, force-related, so...
Correct. Mantle of the Anomic. Yeah, if you talk to the Quartermaster... If you ask him... Roll me a D100.
17. My lucky number.
Unfortunately for you, they do not have any at this time. And
yeah,
not on
it?
Any of the dreadnoughts.
Yes.
How long?
Roll me 2d12.
10.
It's going to take approximately 50 days.
Cool.
Give or take.
That's within the 4 months.
Yep.
How much do you want for it? I'm asking the dude.
Yeah, I'm going to pull up the chart right now.
It's a prototype.
Uh-huh. I'm aware. Okay, so go ahead and roll me a percentile dice. So another D100.
84.
Okay.
Why can't I roll... things high when they should be high and low when they should be low.
So go ahead and roll me a second percentile dice.
11.
I'm using the calculator based on the actual game system.
11.
Okay. So for a prototype item, how much was the first percentile?
84.
Okay. And because it's on the higher end of the rarity spectrum, I would say it's going to cost approximately 2,700.
Not 1,000.
Oh, sorry, it's 27,000. 27,000. Okay. My bad. The extra...
I knew what you meant.
Huh?
I knew what you meant.
The extra is basically the procurement fee. And if you do want this item, you will have to pay it up front. Because,
the whole thing.
Because you're the only person who can use it.
Well, you just ruined my entire haggling plan, so just forget it then, because I can't pay that. I literally don't have enough money.
That's how the calculation goes.
I'm aware. I can't pay it up front. I don't have enough money right now.
How much do you need?
I don't know.
Be 2 grand. You have 25,000, right?
No, I have 18,900.
Okay, well, I have 19,065.
Just pay this 15,000. I had 3 grand and 900 left.
What happened to the rest of the 10 grand I gave you guys?
What are you talking about?
ACOG?
I don't think you gave us 10 grand.
You never gave us 10 grand.
I never gave you that.
No.
Well, shit.
Well.
Do we have 10 grand?
Technically.
As each? A party or each? Yeah.
I would say each because you conquered two planets so far.
Holy.
So that was from Mando.
That changes
okay,
things.
Okay, I do have enough money then.
I was sitting there like, how do you not have enough money?
I haven't spent any money on anything since I bought my lightsaber parts.
That's why I was concerned.
You didn't pay us the job on Montala.
Fine.
You got stiffed.
You paid us in items.
To be fair, those are good items.
Hey, where can I find descriptions of properties?
Properties? Like you want to buy a planet or like what?
Not that kind of property, like a weapon property.
Oh, like a description of properties. That should be under the player's handbook. And it should be under combat.
I don't know if I want to spend all my money on one thing.
I might.
It is pretty good.
Maybe it's not under combat. Maybe it's under conditions.
What, Ryan?
I was just going to ask. So, first question. We have standard availability of standard through prototype, yes?
For the most part, yes.
Okay.
Unless you want force stuff.
Unless you want some really
harder. In other words, Kieran Rocko gets fucked.
I wish that was a thing for me, but not with this character. How much for me to get the medic droid customization part?
Let's take a look and see.
It is just standard.
Medic droid customization. Here it is. Medic droid customization standard part. Go ahead and roll me 2 percentile dice, so that's 2d100s.
Whoops, I need a slash. Woof.
Did you whiff it?
I got a 15 and a 68.
For a 68's not bad. So, let's go here.
So, you would cost approximately 1,680
credits.
1,680? Oh.
1,680. It's a standard item. They're relatively easy to
come by. Yeah, easy. Yeah, let's get that. I'm going to add this to my list here.
Now, you can stabilize
future with. Oh, it's under.
So, this attaches to a droid, so
yep.
you will have to have downtime with Dizzy to attach this.
Yep, that's fine. Have I gotten him back from the forge?
Yes, you have gotten him back.
Okay, cool.
Yes, Tanner.
It is under Wretched Hives equipment, by the way, for the things that
My
I was
bad.
Looking at. Not that I would expect you to know that, but.
Nah, I'm working on it.
Honestly, everything is kind of like all over the place with
it
what it's under.
You just
finding
search for
the
word.
Pain.
It does find it pretty good.
Crox, is there anything you want?
You know, I'm not too sure yet. It's been kind of
looking.
I'm gonna tell you there is something that I think you would like.
Okay.
Let me go ahead and pull this up. There is. Where are you?
Can I equip multiple channels on a single chassis?
Multiple channels on a single chassis?
Yep. It's a focus generator.
Give me a second. Let me take a look. Oh, Crocs, look up the magnetic forearm enhancement.
Oh.
Okay, so it's a focus.
Focus generator for an item modification.
Yep. Focus generator from item modification.
There's like all these different channels that do different things and amplifiers and
so you cannot they basically, like, if you were to put on an advanced and then a superior, the superior would take over.
Okay, but if I do, like,
you cannot
two apprentice.
No, they do not stack.
Okay, not of the same one, different ones. I'm assuming it doesn't.
Well, which ones are you specifically talking about?
I mean, there's a lot. So
yeah, they are.
Any of them?
That's why I'm asking.
Yeah, so if I had one that gave me the ranging property and a different one that gave me the rending property, I'm assuming only one would actually work.
Yeah, so typically the focuses themselves, like the modifications, don't stack unless they say otherwise. And this is where the game gets real complicated, because we're going to start building our own equipment now.
But for the chassis, you need that level of chassis to match that same level of item.
Correct. It has to be, the item has to be at the same chassis level or higher. So if you have an advanced chassis, you can do advanced or lower modifications. Also, Crocs, did you like that one?
Yeah, I like this one. I like that. That's cool.
You want to buy it?
Yeah, let's do it.
They got them.
Nice, let's All do right. it.
Give me some percentile dice. I need two of them.
Okie doke. Can do. Pow.
All right, that's one.
Ah, shit.
Okay.
Sorry.
85.
Alrighty.
That's okay.
Nice. That's a good roll, dude.
Yeah.
So it's going to be 1,850 credits for this item.
Cool. Can do.
Okay.
What's the ready action? Is that just your normal action?
So the ready action is like if you don't take your turn and you ready an action. Like make an attack, cast a spell. It's a ready action.
What?
What do you mean what?
The description of this is weird.
Can you
look up the mitigating casting property? Just search mitigating and it's like right there.
Mitigating?
Mm-hmm.
Mitigating 5. It already has mitigating. Mitigating number increases to 5 to a maximum 6. Okay. So we need to go.
Here, I'll just. I can do this one though. I think I get it.
While using this item as your focus, using the ready action to cast a tech or focus no longer requires concentration. You can only have one instance of this feature active at a time. Additionally, if the power would not be released, and the power was a first level or higher, the cost of the power is reduced by a number of points equal to the mitigation number by a minimum of 1. Oh, okay. I understand. So, for instance, let's say... Oh, God. What's a power that requires concentration?
Haste.
Okay, let's say you wanted to cast haste, but you wanted to ready the action to cast haste, right? If you're technically concentrating on haste, this removes that concentration. So if you get hit, you don't have to make a concentration check before you cast it. It's not great, I'm going to be honest with you.
Interesting. Okay.
But it can come in handy.
That's just for holding spells.
Yeah, that's just for holding spells.
That's really specific.
Or wait, you can only have one instance of this feature active at a time. Wait. No. The first concentration spell you cast is no longer concentration.
But you have to use your ready action to cast it?
Using the ready action to cast a force power no longer. Yeah, so if you cast a concentration spell as a ready action, it will no longer be a concentration spell. You'll have all the bonuses without concentration.
So is that just like using your whole turn instead of just using an action?
It's basically full rounding your turn to get rid of concentration for a spell.
What item is this?
This is the mitigating property.
Yeah.
While using this item as a focus, using the ready action to cast a force or tech power no longer requires concentration. You can only have one instance of this feature active at a time. Additionally, if the power would not be released, the power was first level or higher, the cost is reduced by a number of points equal to the mitigating number to a minimum of one. Yeah, honestly, that's broken. Holy shit. So... that's spicy.
Hold on, that's a part of me wants to say there's no way. That seems really dumb.
Based on the wording alone, I would say that is how it functions. He has to use his whole turn to cast the concentration spell, but then it is no longer concentration.
Hold on.
Action.
No, it's because... No, I think your first interpretation... Using a ready action to cast a force power no longer requires concentration.
Then read the next part.
You only have one instance of this feature active time, so you can't ready, like, two actions.
You don't usually ready two actions anyway.
I'm going to try to find it, but I think it's saying you have to concentrate on a force or tech power to release it as a reaction, not on your turn. I think they require concentration for that in this series.
Yeah, which means, say, for instance, he has Nightspeed going on right now, and he wants to ready, like, stun, for instance.
Mm-hmm.
No, I think it means if you are holding an action to cast a force power, doesn't matter what it is, even if it does require concentration, you are now concentrating on it to release the spell. If you get hit before it goes off, you have to make a con save to be able to still cast it later when it triggers.
Yeah. And likewise, because it's no longer concentration, it doesn't automatically end another concentration, in this case, like Nightspeed in the case of Keel.
Okay, no, I found it. Yeah, the ready action is really specific. It's holding your action. When you ready a power, you cast it as normal but hold its energy, which you release with your reaction when the trigger occurs. To be readied, a power must have a casting time of one action, and holding onto the power's effect requires concentration.
Okay, so they added that. Okay, so that makes sense, and so you would not require concentration to hold to ready the action. That's meh.
I don't hold actions often.
Yeah, no one holds
actions. It's good to know, I guess, in case I ever hold a force power, but whatever.
Yeah, but you're never going to hold a force power unless it's, like, something big and awful.
It's interesting.
Very different.
Anyway.
Ryan, anything you want?
Yes. Can I get the... It's a premium item. It's the Fine Vocoder for droid customization. Allows the vocoder to include 10 languages and grants the droid the ability to speak, read, and write each language.
Yeah, please. I'm tired of beeping and booping.
I can't hear Katie.
Yeah. She's basically...
Sorry,
she was gonna...
I was muted. I was gonna buy us all translators so we could understand Dizzy, so I'm glad
you're
doing that.
Oh, I'm way ahead of you. I was waiting.
Good.
I already have one.
Well, yeah, but the rest of us don't.
I've got a translator for me, but now Dizzy, we don't need them.
Now Dizzy would be able to speak basic and 10 other languages, which means he could also be an interpreter for you guys.
Right.
Good. That'll be nice.
Turns him into a rolling protocol droid.
The useful droid becomes more useful.
Yes. Yes. Okay, in that case, let me quickly go backwards here. Roll me two percentile dice.
Okay. Ooh, wrong keyboard. I'm still working.
That's okay. I won't give you too much shit.
39 and 63.
Okay. Gotta do some math here.
I have a question when you're done with Ryan.
Okay. I also have my shopping list ready. I'm gonna go get a slice of pizza, though.
Okay.
Okay, I'll be here.
What do you, if something doesn't have the rarity listed on it?
What do you mean? What, like, what item?
The medium shield generator. It just has a cost.
Then that should be just a normal
item. And that's just the cost.
Cool, I would like to buy that. It's 375 credits.
Done.
Sick! My AC is 19.
Is that the handheld one?
No, it's the shield generator.
Okay. I will say you'll have to spend about $1,000 to get a belt to put it on. Otherwise, because technically you're supposed to still hold it, but no. Just add $1,000 to it.
I already have that because I have the light shield generator. So I'm just swapping them out.
Oh, then fine.
Okay.
Okay, so, plus... Ryan, your cost for the vocoder is going to be 5,907 credits.
Whoa! I love how that's more expensive than the medic kit. 5,900 and what now?
Seven.
Oh, seven. Okay.
That's and because a medic kit is very easy to come by.
Yes. 08. And last one, as far as, like, enhanced items. Can sure. I get a blaster integration for Dizzy?
Where is that?
That is also an enhanced item. It is a standard enhancement, or standard rarity. It is a droid customization.
Blaster integration. Now, a single simple or martial blaster into your... You don't need that. You've already got it.
Okay, cool.
That's where the railgun's coming in.
Copy that. Okay, well, I will do some more looking as far as, like, weapons for Zego.
Okay. I'll give you guys another 10 minutes to look at some stuff, and then we will go ahead and move on. And then, of course, if you guys want anything after the session, please feel free to let me know.
My turn!
Okay, what's your turn?
So I need you to look at two things. Okay, I need to see how much a channel and this would be... Basically, I need a chassis and a channel. But I want to look at the prices for either advanced or premium for the set for either.
Hey guys, I'm just going to hop off for a little bit, okay?
Okay. All right,
man. Yeah. All right. Sorry, Connor was messaging me. So you want me to look at a channel and what?
So I need a channel and chassis.
Channel and chassis. Okay.
And I need it for either advanced or premium. Depending on how much.
Interesting. So let's talk premium first and see what we can do. There are several channels. Is there a particular one you want?
Amplifying is the one I'm looking at.
Amplifying. Okay. It already has it. What does amplifying do?
It increases crit range.
Okay.
On melee force spell attacks, specifically.
Melee force spell attacks, which is going to be gross for you.
Yep.
I'm going to tell you, just because this is a force power type item, it's going to be a lot more expensive.
Uh-huh.
So keep that in mind.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So for the premium one, go ahead and roll me again 2 percentile dice.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so come on. So for the premium version of it, it will be 8,210 credits.
Is that for just the channel?
Just the channel.
Say it again.
8,210.
Mm-hmm.
And then you need a chassis.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a focus chassis. Nope, that's a wrist pad.
I can tell you it's called the Focus Generator Chassis.
There it is. Okay, so for a premium Focus Generator Chassis, comes with a vacant modifications. Comes with vacant modifications as well as one augment slot. Can hold modifications of prototype rarity or lower. It's weird that it doesn't say how many. Just comes with vacant slots. Cool.
I'm only going to use one.
I know. It can house modifications of prototype rarity or lower. It will probably cost around the same amount because it's the same rarity. Just aim for about $8,000 for that as well. And do you want me to check for the advanced ones?
Yes.
Okay. I'm gonna tell you right now. The answer is you don't have enough.
I might get close, actually.
All right. So let me do this. And this. And give me, again, a 2 percentile dice, please.
Here, I got to step away for a minute, too. I will get in touch with you after the session if I need any other weapons, because I'll probably be back by the time that... with all this.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. We'll be fine. Okay. So for advanced, it is, what did you roll? 55? Cool. Yikes. Okay. Based on the random generated number that I'm using, because I'm stupid, the chassis alone, if you go for an advanced, is going to be about 120,000.
Okay.
Well, because remember, it is a high rarity, and I also just used a random number generator to just determine it, because that's a lot of money.
Didn't you say up to 25?
No, for an advanced, it starts at 25. Goes to 100.
Okay.
Prototype stops at 25.
Oh, hold up. Hold on, wait, do they not have a prototype for this? I don't think they do. Okay, yeah, so it skips. It goes from premium to advanced. Okay.
No, there's a prototype. I'm looking right at it.
Not for the channel.
Oh, for the channel?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's weird.
They have other channels that have prototype, but not for amplifying.
That's weird. Okay.
Well, it goes from a 19 to an 18 crit range, so...
Yeah, that's pretty good. And I will tell you guys, don't panic. You will be paid more.
I'm not worried about it.
I'm not skimping out on you guys. Payment is coming.
Oh, I wasn't worried about it.
So you will be able to purchase the higher level items. It's just not yet.
Yeah, I'll get the advanced set.
You mean the prototype set? Or the premium?
Nope, the advanced. Or sorry, the premium. I'm staring at advanced, so I said it, but it's the premium.
Yeah, one. I'm sitting here like, with what money? Okay. In which case, it's going to be, like I said,
I say put it on 16. His tab, and I point at ACOG. He already has one.
Amazing!
For shits and giggles, can you roll me persuasion at disadvantage? Can do.
Oof.
Yeah, no.
Am I there?
No, that's... Damn. That would be an individual thing. No, you do not get it. Man, if you rolled high enough, though, I would have totally done it and been like, hey, Chad, you've lost a bunch of money.
Definitely.
You're down 100 grand.
You're not sure, but it might be because you were drunk most of the session.
You have acquired more gambling debt.
The gamble was you worked on Kiel's team.
Yeah, the gamble was you're friends with Kiel. But yeah, go ahead and add the chassis and the channeling, or the amplifying one, to your thing.
It will
be a premium condition, so whatever that information entails.
Yep.
And I'm going to be honest with you guys, for simplicity's sake, the chassis have 2 mod slots, 1 augment slot. That's it. You can't just keep adding to it.
Can we have more than one chassis?
You may. They can't be the same kind of chassis, but yes, you can have multiple chassis.
Sick.
So you can have a weapons chassis, an armor chassis, a cloak chassis, and so on and so forth.
Okay.
It's going to be a really expensive build, but it is possible.
Okay.
Yeah, that's about right. Okay, so Ryan will be back, at least in the voice chat, but he's still here. On that note, we are exactly 9:30. I am so glad. You guys, while shopping on this big dreadnought, which is weird saying because you're on a military base and you're shopping like it's, you know, Target.
We're at the mall.
Let's go to the mall.
It's going down. Meet me at the club. It's going down.
All right. You guys are then contacted through your personal communications devices. And it is a message that says, please come to the bridge. Cassis is waiting for you.
Great.
Okay.
Great. Who's that, Ryan, that just joined back?
Yes, it was.
Hey, we're being summoned by Cassis.
For the love of all the...
Your favorite dude.
Agreement.
You came back at the perfect time.
No! Fuck that!
I'm leaving again!
Yeah, for real.
I rage quit.
Cassis can't boss me around if I'm not in the voice chat.
Guys.
All right. Well, I will leave it up to you guys. You can go.
Yeah.
Or you can choose to ignore him.
No,
I'll find Kiel first. And then I'll go.
Okay.
Look what I got! Turns on my shield generator.
Ooh.
A light blue shimmer hovers just above her skin.
That's cool. I could do that with the Force.
I mean, I probably could figure it out, but...
Subtle flex.
I can teach you, it's not hard.
Humble brag.
For real.
Mean? Can't you just be excited about my cool new shield generator?
Calm down.
Picking on me.
Give me 2 minutes, I'm gonna be right back.
I'm gonna take Dizzy with us.
Someone set up a timer, quick. 2 minute timer, go.
Listen, I'm just annoyed they don't have nachos on this dreadnought.
I mean, I can make you nachos on the ship, on our ship.
I didn't want to make it. I wanted to buy it. I have so much money.
Okay, well, I'll make them, and then you can pay me for it, and it'll be like you bought them. Does that work?
Squints at you.
What else did you guys get?
I got a lightsaber thing.
Sweet.
I got a shield, and I have something else on order.
Cool.
Dizzy's got a, did I put that on his chart, by the way?
Dizzy's got a gun.
I did order the cloak,
I had a
for the record.
So you removed the amount that it cost?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
That's all my money.
Dizzy's got a gun.
Dizzy's a medic, and he can, he's basically our own personal translator now. He can talk to us, and we can talk back to him. No problem.
Nice.
Okay.
Honestly, Dizzy is one step away from just being Chopper.
Rick, yeah, he is. Let's go.
Rico waves at Dizzy. Hi. You're useful. You can stay.
I'm gonna approach Dizzy, like look at him, and be like, "Can you understand me?" As I pet him on the head with my robotic hand.
Oh my god, he's not dumb, Daito.
Yeah, Dizzy's gonna pull a little shock prod out and zap your finger.
Got him.
R2D2 style.
For everyone's information, there has not been a downtime, so he does not have the vocoder or the medic pack until a downtime happens.
Right.
So.
Oh, damn.
No, he can understand you, still can't talk.
Well, he can talk, we just can't understand him.
Correct.
Gail and I have our translators. Yeah, we're chilling.
All right. But as you guys make your way through the dreadnought and up to the bridge, you see several people standing around a massive hollow terminal in the center of this bridge. Several things are on there, multiple planets, a massive star map, and points that look to be representations of ships or fleets. We're not entirely sure. But as you come onto the bridge, Cassis will go ahead and turn it off, and then immediately turn around and address the party. Ah,
can we make a perception check to see who was on the or what was on the thing?
Sure.
Ooh, I want to get in on that. Can I roll too?
You, anybody who wants to try, may.
Yo, fucking
let's go.
Okay.
This is my best perception check I'm ever gonna have as Z.
Anybody
ever.
Else?
Nope.
Cool. Daito, are you doing anything? Or are you just chilling?
I'm just chilling right now.
He's just cool. Happy to be here.
He sees without trying. What do you mean?
I'm just enjoying my new magnetic form.
However, ooh. I will say this. For this moment, unless he was actively looking for something, I will not be using his passive perception.
Sure.
However, Z, as like Ryko, when you look at it, you don't see a whole lot because he turns it off pretty quick. Z, however, sees this thing and like almost picture perfect memorizes some of the points on the map. You notice there are several fleets that are in orbit around some planets clustered nearby. This one is the largest. There are some stray ships on different routes. And there was a singular planet circled, but you didn't quite catch the name of it.
Got it. Cool. Thanks.
Cool. I will tell you one thing. It starts with a K. Anyway.
Ooh, Cassis
will turn and address the group. Ah. You weren't late. I'm surprised.
Okay.
Welcome to the bridge. I see you all have indulged yourselves with some of the things that we offer. Which is a wonderful welcoming surprise. You may need them today.
Today?
Correct. You see, today I have decided I want to see you all work together with my own eyes. I want to see your abilities so I may best use them.
Okay.
Therefore, I have decided to do a training exercise. A bonding exercise, if you will.
Yeah, don't call it that, please.
I will. It is a bonding exercise. It will be two teams, yours and another. We will be inside of our training arena. Weapons will be free. However, ammunition will be dummy rounds only. This is not to the death, unless you wish it.
Question.
Answer. What if we don't use ammo?
I'm asking Cassis a question.
Answer.
So dummy rounds for ammunition, sure. What about our lightsabers?
Yes. We will figure that one out. We may give you all some of our... Basically, it's like a training saber. As energy weapons, energy sabers do exist. Most people don't use them. They do exist.
I think I'll just use my knucklers.
So you would be using the same stats as your weapons, but you would lose the bonuses of the crystals.
Ooh.
Because the crystals are what causes the damage.
I want the crit though.
I was just gonna use my vibro knucklers anyway.
Cyber, don't make me re-stat my entire crit mechanic. Can I just use my regular lightsaber? Doesn't hurt that much.
Do you want to hurt the people
hurt that much?
It cauterizes the wounds.
Yeah, it's good.
Very well. I will allow it if you so wish.
No, it's fine. I'll just use my double blade instead that I totally have programmed in here somewhere.
No, you'll still use your Buster Saber and everything like that. It just won't have the crit range. That's all.
It'll have the crit range of 19.
Yes, because of your bonus ability.
Okay, let me just go change that real quick.
That's an easy change.
Yeah, you guys, all you have to do is just change the abilities. So, Keel, you would not have the poison or the heal aura.
Yep.
I'm just going to uncheck my extra damage because that is also from the crystal.
Very well. Then let me go ahead and introduce you to your opposing team. And then he will reach up and tap his pad as the door behind you opens and in walks Threg, Avo,
I knew it!
And another character.
Oh, you guys gonna die.
Rygo looks directly at Threg and she goes, "You're gonna pay for that ship comment."
He pulls out a sniper you have not seen before and cocks it and goes, "You can try, girly." And then he puts it up on his shoulder and goes, "I've taken it easy on you. Now we're going to show you what real Mandalorians do."
I am a real Mandalorian, thank you.
Yeah, okay.
I'm sorry, are you arguing with Mandalore?
And then Cassis will go, Children, enough. I have no time for this. Make your way down to the battlefield. We will settle this like real warriors."
God, he's so boring.
As we leave, I'm like, he obviously has time for this. Why would he say that? We're doing a whole training exercise that he wants to see.
He's boring. That's why. We can't have fun with it.
He's boring.
He is boring. It's literally business only with him. God. Yes. Have a fucking hobby, Cassis. Take a day off.
Welcome to Cassis.
Jedi in the head.
His hobby is ruining our lives.
His yeah, hobby honestly. Is ruining our lives.
For real, though.
Okay. I'm putting your characters on the tile.
I'm so fucking up, Threg. I can't
Will you add Dizzy to that, please?
I have already done so.
My man. Okay, just for the record, today, he has the Eldritch Cannon.
I already knew that.
All right, squad.
We have not time skipped yet.
No,
what's that?
We've not time skipped, yeah.
We have not time skipped at this point.
All right, squad, gather up.
What's the plan? Oh, ooh. I have another question, actually. Sorry, Tanner.
Hmm?
My saber teleport stuff, I have to be like, have to have my saber to that.
You, for sake of brevity, the answer is yes.
Okay, thank you.
Sorry, go ahead, Tanner. I'm not going to make you change all of your shit.
Thanks.
What a guy.
All right, what, Tanner?
All right, squad, gather up. Are we playing man-to-man? Is everyone picking one person and going for it? Or how Dibs do you want to do this?
Dibs, Threg.
If we do that, that's fine. You guys want to go man-to-man?
He's going to see us work as a team, so yes, we could do we man-to-man probably but, work like, as support a team. Each other.
Yeah, I mean, I like that idea.
Yeah.
Z, probably fight someone that's not quiet. She kicked your ass.
For real. I kind of want to now that I've got my droid, though, so we'll see.
Actually,
what
Z, I want you to take Avo, because she's the medic.
Okay.
I want her out of the fight first.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe we for should focus on her.
Time.
For sake of simplicity, Ryan, Z does not know about Avo.
Being a medic?
Yeah, because that hasn't happened yet.
Your thing has not happened yet. You do not know her stuff. Keep that in mind.
Oh, yes. Okay. Yes. Copy that.
Okay.
Oh, I forgot she was on his mission. Yeah.
Correct. All right. So, anything else you guys want to do?
Can we pre-buff?
So, the answer is no.
Ah, boo. I say that.
I can't hour-long pre-buff my party on the way down.
Absolutely fucking not. This is a skill-based thing, not a I'm going to buff myself until I'm invincible.
No, I'm going to buff everyone until we're invincible.
Skill issue. All right. You guys get down this elevator, and Avo, Thraeg, the whole crew are with you guys. There is one man you don't recognize, but the three primary NPCs are there. I'm working on it.
I'm storytelling. Hang on.
As you guys enter this large square room, you notice a couple of things. The walls are completely bare, and the floor is full of hexagons.
Ew, however, don't you dare put this on a hexagon grid map.
I'm putting it on a hexagonal map.
I fucking hate it so much.
Get fucked.
Is it still 5-foot hexagons?
Don't worry about it. Hang on.
I'm
just
worried about it.
Listen. God. One of the Neo Crusaders wearing red armor stands in the center of the arena. And as you all look up, one of the walls opens and elongates out, creating a balcony that Cassis and several others begin to stand on. As soon as the movement of the balcony stops, the Red Mandalorian will speak. This is a test of skill, and only skill. You are to work with your teams in a death match. And then Cassis just coughs for a minute. Apologies. Training exercise.
Boring.
It is a 4-on-4, and he looks over and sees Dizzy. Looks up at Cassis.
And a half.
Sir,
and
Cassis waves him off, and he goes, "Very well. It is a 4-on-4 plus a droid."
Doesn't Thraeg have a droid though?
Yeah, Thraeg has a droid too. It's totally fair.
Ooh, spicy.
4.5 on a 4.5.
Spicy.
Once I leave this room, you will be told to go by our leader Cassis. At that moment, all weapons are free. All attacks are to be non-lethal unless deemed otherwise. Are these conditions clear?
Yes, sir.
Yep.
All four of the other Mandalorian NPCs, without saying anything, just nod in approval. Very good. And then he immediately walks off the field. As soon as he leaves, Cassis raises his hand and yells, "Begin!" And then the floors change as the hexes raise up and create barriers.
It's Ender's Game!
And you know what this is now... giving? This is giving the D&D movie.
Kinda.
And now,
holy
please
crap,
enter initiative.
Holy cow.
You're gonna have to give me a hot minute. I have several charts to pull up.
Oh, that's what's up.
Yes!
Hey, let's go!
I'm into this turn order! Let's go!
Wait, hold on. I should be above Keel. I have a higher initiative bonus. There we go.
All right, I'm pulling up all of my charts.
Everyone rolled fucking good on that, except
Wyatt.
Except for me.
Yeah, sorry, bud.
It's whatever.
It happens.
Thraeg rolls at advantage, goddamn.
Hell yeah, get shit
if
on
we
it.
All get to go before any of them, I'm into that.
I realize
okay, I
so
spoke
fucking
too soon.
Hard, dude. Two of us get to go before Avo.
Okay. Then I'm going to go ahead and
man,
set up the turn order.
That initiative advantage
is real sad.
Rolled exactly like how Tanner rolls initiative
yep.
on advantage.
Correct.
All right. To give you guys context, all of the smaller squares are 5 foot tall. The middle, however, is a 10 foot tall and has a repulsor field, meaning you cannot stand on top of it.
Can you go through it?
You can climb over it, but you cannot stop there.
Can I see through it?
No.
So they can't see us?
Not at the moment, they can't.
Okay.
So, Daito, you may go.
Yes, sir, yes, sir. 50 feet, okay. Let's move to here. And...
I've never started combat with all of my force points.
You're gonna need them.
Oh boy.
Okay, Daito's turn is over. It is now Dizzy's turn.
I'm gonna go straight ahead.
Okay. Anything he wants to do with his attack or action or bonus action?
Does the railgun require a tech point to fire?
No. It is your bonus action to fire. Action. No, it's your bonus action.
Oh. Oh, yes, yes, yes. You're right. Okay, that's it.
Okay. It is Avo's turn then. As she immediately, you guys hear a button as she flies up.
Oh, yeah, let's go.
And cheater.
I love it. Let's see. How much is... Oh, I can't use it. That sucks.
Why?
Spicy. I love it.
So this area is the field, the repulsor currently, field?
That is 10 feet up, and there is a repulsor field. So if you are on one or the other side, it will push you off immediately.
Okay.
Yeah, I think we're going to go ahead and do that. Z?
Sure.
I need you to make me a constitution saving throw.
No!
You fail.
Do I save that? Wait.
Nope, that is a failure.
Damn it.
She's going to teleport you over there. You're so fucked.
She immediately yeets you over.
That's amazing.
This is actually really funny for story. This is me out of character. This is hilarious.
And then immediately disappears and appears on the other side of the field.
It's gonna be great.
Dude, Rygo starts fucking laughing. Have fun!
And then... Avo will use her bonus action...
Fuck.
to go ahead and take aim at Dizzy and fire her hand cannon.
Why'd you piss off Avo, Z?
I didn't do anything! What do you mean?!
She's targeting you real fucking hard, dude!
She will go ahead and use her ability Precise Shot.
Yo,
Medic Precision.
I don't have any saves! That sucks.
And do 15 damage to Dizzy.
Woo!
Jeez, please.
But that is the end of her turn. It is now Ryko's turn.
Dizzy's got 2 HP left right off the bat.
Jesus.
How high up is Avo?
Avo is 30 feet up.
So if I move to here, can I still see her?
Yes, you should still be able to see her.
Make sure. Oh, that's too far. If I move to here. Can I still see her now?
Yeah.
Pythagorean theorem?
Not enough.
60 feet?
More than 60? Are you asking 60. For
60 feet?
No, you should be able to hit.
It'd be 50 to 55.
Sick.
With Pythagorean.
Yeah, you should be able to hit. Improved saber throw. Neat.
Is a crit hit?
yeah, crit will hit. You did not use your bonus action.
Bonus action?
Okay,
sorry, you may use your bonus action.
Got to make sure you tell me in advance,
sorry.
Otherwise.
I'm also gonna teleport to her.
You cannot.
Oh, you're right, it's within 30 feet. My saber comes back to me then.
Yep, your saber will go ahead and return to you. So, 23 damage. Ow. Avo is hurting.
And then, hold on.
As the same weapon's damage, must make a constitution saving throw or takes 2d8 additional damage.
And a slowed level. No, you just take the slowed level.
No, I have to make a constitution saving throw.
Saving throw, or you'd get a slowed level, not additional damage.
Oh, okay. So yeah, let me go ahead and make that. Con save. Nope.
Cool.
He is now slowed.
Lose 15 feet of movement.
All right.
And that is the saber returns to my hand, and the next attack. So I have a question for you. It says the next attack made against the target that hits it before the end of the target's next turn. Is that an attack from anyone or me?
Anyone.
Cool. Whoever hits Avo next gets more force damage. Just keep that in mind.
So it's like Guiding Bolt, but kind of.
It's Guiding Bolt, but scarier.
It's different.
All right. Anything else?
No.
All right. Keel, you're up.
I have so many things I want to do.
I really was relying on that teleport, because I don't think I can get over there otherwise.
Well, I'm gonna get to here, and then I gotta decide.
Ooh, I know what I'm doing.
I really wish.
Now, keep in mind, you cannot see over this wall at the moment unless you climb over it.
Correct.
You can only see Avo because she is in the air.
Correct.
Oh, you made this room exactly the right size for me.
We'll see.
I'm going to...
Hi.
If
can
I just
give him a boost?
If I just stand here, can I see Z?
You can see Z. However, at the end of your turn, you will be pushed back onto the left side of the wall.
That's fine. I can move off. I just need to get here.
All right. You're climbing over the wall?
Partially.
Okay. Just give me a quick acrobatics or athletics.
Oh, you're good at one of those.
I mean...
I'm good at one of those.
I'm not going to end my turn here. Does that matter?
No, but to climb over the wall, because it is higher than what you can see over, so you have to climb over.
Okay.
It will not be your turn. I'm just asking if you're going to do that. I need a check.
Well,
you climb the wall.
Okay.
Let's go.
On the way. On the way.
I'm proficient in acrobatics.
Hell no! I'm a wizard.
Oh. He's a wizard. He ain't
skills and stuff.
That's where I got poison from. That's from my background. on my way over the wall, I'm going to increase the distance and cast rescue on Z.
Oh, I'm into that.
Okay.
I like that idea.
So,
you have to use your reaction, Ryan.
Yeah, so you have to use your reaction to accept it.
I use distant power.
To use an extra force point to double the distance.
Okay. So it is now 60 feet.
Yep. And it was my action to dash. I still have a bonus action to do this. And I'm going to pull him into the square behind me right here.
I accept.
Okay. Then you go ahead and you move to the square behind him.
Okay.
Huzzah.
And... I'm going to finish my turn by moving here.
Okay.
Whole room is at least 10 feet tall, yeah.
For the wall in the center?
The whole room.
The whole room is much taller than 10 feet.
Check it.
Otherwise, Keel could not have gone over that wall, and Avo could not be flying.
Just checking.
Okay, then it is Z's turn.
Yeah, well, I have to rethink some things now.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Thank you. I also acrobatics to climb over the wall.
Okay.
I just put you back there.
Just hang on. Hang on.
This.
That is the guy you do not recognize.
Oh, okay, I was going to say, who the fuck?
Okay, I'm right here.
Okay.
That's my move.
Yep.
And I'm going to take a shot with my hand blaster. at Avo up in the air.
Take a shot. 21 hits.
I roll an additional d10 for force damage from my spell.
You roll an additional d10.
Plus two.
Damn.
That's okay. Damage is damage.
That's right. Eight more damage on top of the 23 I've already done.
Yeah, for real. Okay. 31 total damage.
Z, anything else?
I bonus action translocate back to the other side so that I don't have to get pushed off onto the right hand side.
Okay. So you bamf back over.
Yep. Trust me, cool. I know what I'm doing, Keel. I got this.
I mean, you could have just moved too. You had 15 feet of movement left.
It is Thrag's turn.
That's true.
Oh, I feel so bad for doing this.
I don't.
Thrag is going to use several things right now.
Oh, Lord have.
He's going to. So, Keel.
Hi.
You're the only one who currently sees this.
Correct.
As Thrag is holding his sniper rifle like in a parade rest, he immediately hits one knee, holds the sniper up against his shoulder, and holds it for just a moment, and you see a red dot appear on your chest.
Shit.
He is taking his shot with advantage.
Sure.
Where's my toggle button? Am I rolling everything at advantage or no? Yeah, I am. Okay, cool. Alright.
Misses.
17. Okay. He'll make a second attack. 28.
Yep.
Warning. Do not do what you're about to see at home.
Is Thrag saying that?
No, I'm telling you all this. It's about to get real bad.
Fuck.
So
it's not lethal.
It is non-lethal. However, he gets to add a bunch of damage to this.
Mm-hmm. Which is doubled.
Yep. And then he adds an additional 3d6 to this.
Which is doubled?
That is not doubled.
Good. He has acid damage? What the hell?
Acid damage. This is a disruptor rifle.
All right.
Is that the type of rifle that I've been asking for?
No. Okay. That is a disintegrator rifle.
Yeah, that's the one I want.
Everyone wants a disintegrator rifle.
I'm proficient in snipers, though.
It does 21 damage.
Okay.
Dude, Keel's fine.
And then you notice that your body is kind of like weirdly glowing.
Okay.
For sake of clarification, every attack against you for the next turn is at advantage, and you do not benefit from cover.
Okay.
It is Quiet's turn. And this is where things get extra spicy. Quiet is going to run up.
Does she have 40 feet of movement?
She does.
What the hell? Okay.
It's crazy.
I'm not surprised.
I promise
by that
you.
In the slightest.
Okay. So this is at advantage, obviously. 18.
Force shield.
You're going to force shield it?
Yep.
All right. As you force shield it, she is going to immediately bonus action disengage. And she's gonna stay. She's gonna stay.
Okay. I thought she was gonna hit you really, really hard.
This guy, however,
is gonna shoot you three times.
Mm-hmm.
Kablammo, miss. Kablammo, mm-hmm. miss. Kablammo, 22.
Let me read something real quick. My AC goes up until the end of my next turn, so that misses.
Okay. So he is gonna go ahead and move this direction.
On the ground?
He is on the ground.
Everyone's on the ground except Avo, yeah?
Everyone is on the ground except for Avo. Daito, you are up.
Let's go. Okay. So, this was 10 feet over, right? Over
it
the,
is 10 feet over, yes.
Okay. So.
Which for a monk should be no problem.
Come on over, the water is bloody. I mean, fine.
I can get to there. Okay, cool. That's a me.
Okay, you don't want to use your action to, like, dash or anything?
Not as of yet.
Okay. It is Dizzy's turn.
He hurts.
He hurts a lot.
He hurts.
I can heal him with my force healing, sorry.
No, nope. If he goes down, he's down this fight. Dizzy can see Avo, yes?
Dizzy can see Avo, yes.
Okay, I'm gonna do this. That's gonna freaking hit, sir!
I want to remind you, you have to use Z's bonus action to fire that gun.
You're right! Damn it.
You don't need a bonus action, you're fine.
I love how you rolled a 20 and a 6.
However, for flavor, I'm going to allow it.
You got a 1.
For flavor, I'll allow it, because it's funny.
I'm adding the stipulation on my
thing. Make sure to add that stipulation. However, for flavor, I'm going to allow it. So that's okay, 22 that's damage.
Literally, you had enough movement to go back over the wall, so you didn't need to use your bonus action last turn anyway.
Yeah, I know.
It is pushed up to 5 feet away from the cannon. So she goes back one tile.
Great.
Anything else?
He's going to come back and hide right behind this thing.
Fair. Martin.
Okay, that's my turn.
Okay. What do I want to do here?
Ooh, I'm going to do something spicy.
Hopefully I can do something spicy here in a second.
So I'm going to have Avo use Tracer Bolt, which is basically Guiding Bolt. So she's going to go ahead and hit Keel since he's standing front and center.
Hi.
And she knows about you. She's going to go ahead and DPS you down. So it is 2d20 plus 6.
Is she going to attack first?
This is what I'm doing. I'm rolling.
Oh, 2d20. Okay.
I don't have it set in there, so it's a 23.
That is my AC, dang.
Damn. Alright, so it's 4d6. 17.
Okay.
It doesn't say what... Oh, it is energy damage. And you haven't used your ability yet, have you?
Okay. I probably won't, to be honest.
Fair enough. And then she's going to go ahead and take a hand cannon shot at Dizzy, because why not? Nah, fuck it. Shoot Keel.
Can't see him.
Yeah, I know. That's why I'm saying I can't do it. So shoot Keel.
Yep.
A kablam.
Nope.
Okay. And that is going to be the end of Oppo's turn. He is going to go ahead and jump down and take cover behind one of these things. So now no one can see Avo. It is Riker's
turn. Is that including her minus 15 movement that she had this turn?
Yep.
She just dropped, so with the jetpack, which is just, 15.
Yep.
I have several questions.
I have one answer.
How tall are these?
They are 5 feet.
Okay. I would like to ask a question before I do this.
I might have an answer for you.
So it's 10 feet for me to get to the wall. It's 10 feet for me to climb up the wall.
Yes.
And then I can walk across this, but if I stand up there, it pushes me off, yeah?
It will push you to the side you are closest to.
Okay, at the end of my turn, though.
At the end of your turn.
Okay, I have a question. Can I jump from here to here?
That will require an acrobatics check.
Okay, do you think it would be a hard acrobatics check? It's only a five-foot jump.
It's technically 10-foot jump.
And I also am going to have a 15-foot running start.
I will take it into account. I will say the DC would be 15.
Okay. Then, if I make that, this is dependent on quite a few things. Then can I jump off of this?
No.
Why not?
That would be the end of your movement.
No, I'm going to roll my force and power thingy.
Oh, well, that's if you roll force and power.
It's dependent on a lot of things. I'm asking a lot of hypotheticals before I decide if I want to do this or not.
Okay.
Can I jump and throw my saber at the same time?
Yeah.
Cool. I'm going to roll my force-empowered self slow time. So I roll a D10, not a D12. I roll a D10, and it's a D10, right?
This is a D8, I think.
D8. You're right. I roll a D8, and then whatever I roll that times 5 adds to my movement speed.
Yeah.
Okay. So...
you get 15 extra movement.
Damn, I don't think... That would put me at 45. I don't think that's enough. Count again. So that's 10.
Up is 20.
Yeah, so 10, 20, 30, 40, 45. Just far away. Would I be able to see Avo from here?
She does have cover, three quarters cover. So
even though if I was standing up here,
she is ducking behind it, like she is kneeling behind it. You can see her, but it would be a higher AC.
All right, fine, new plan. I was gonna try and get the thread because I want to get in his face, but that's not gonna happen this turn. So I'm gonna move to here.
Okay.
That was 10, 20, 30 movement speed, so I have 15 left. I am going to bonus action lightsaber form.
Okay.
And then I am going to saber throw, regular saber throw.
Okay.
Never mind. That does nothing. Cool. I'm done. That was a waste of my turn.
What do you mean?
There's no way a 12 hits quiet.
Oh.
That
didn't pop up for me. That's why I was like, what do you mean?
Yeah, I'm done. That was a waste of my turn.
Then you will go ahead and just drop down.
You still got 15 feet of movement if you want to do something.
You do still have 15 feet if you wanted to do anything else.
No, it's fine.
All right. Then it is Keel's turn.
Cypher, I can see everyone, yes. Right?
Yes, technically.
I'm going to cast Improved Phase Strike. I have to double the distance on it so I can hit everyone, but I'm going to hit everyone now.
Okay.
What does it cost for double distance? One additional force point. Okay.
Only one to double the distance for any spell. That's crazy.
I think that's what it said, yeah.
When you cast a power that has a range of 5 feet or greater, spend one additional point to double the range of the power. Alternative, when you cast a power that has a range of touch.
Is that a class thing?
Yeah.
That's a sorcery point thing.
It's a sorcery point thing. That's nuts. Cool. Go ahead.
I hit all of them. So.
Okay.
Thrig.
Yes. That'll hit.
Avo.
That'll miss.
Who's right next to me?
That's Quiet. That's
Quiet.
Actually, hold up. That will also hit.
And the new dude.
New dude. New dude is also hit.
Okay.
Honestly, that's good because Avo's kind of beat up, I think.
I think I'm going to roll Defiant on Thrag and see if I hit.
You don't think you can roll Defiant if I tell you you fail or pass.
Also, you already hit Thrag.
Or who did I miss on? Avo?
You missed
Avo.
Double check
Defiant wording.
This is Avo.
You can use it before or after the roll.
You're right.
It's determined.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay, then.
Oh, no. Before or after the roll, but before the GM determines the outcome.
Yeah. And you already rolled your next roll, so I'm going to say you cannot use Defiant.
That's fine. We're chilling.
You got 3. Also, Avo's been crit twice.
You don't have Defiant.
What?
You gave it to Ryko when you guys were shopping.
Shopping? No.
Or no, when you talked to the Cathar, you gave her Defiant.
Was that
to
on
persuader.
The same day? Because we were
this
like
is the same day.
Was it within an hour? Because I think we were shopping for a couple hours.
Yeah. Okay. Fine. I'll let you have it. Mm. But still, the answer is you cannot use it against Avo as you've already rolled.
That's fine. So starting from the top.
Okay. So this is Thrag.
Actually, I'm just gonna roll this here because I think I had a different thing for this. So it's 6d10 each.
Yep.
That's really
Jeez,
consistent.
Geez. Let's
okay.
go.
I see.
Also, all of the ones and twos are threes.
Okay.
There's only three twos.
There's not many.
So
twos.
Two more damage on the second one and one more damage on the third one.
Yep.
Okay, so
33,
34,
35. Very consistent.
Was that 34 damage? Okay, and then the last guy is 35 damage.
Also, as the last part of that spell, I can teleport within 5 feet of one of those creatures that I just hit. I am now here.
Oh, you bitch! I wanted Thrag.
I mean, he's just the problem.
Okay. I mean, I'm about to. Well, I'll wait.
That's my action.
That's my action.
Oh, yo, wait! I add an extra D8 to all of those because I took damage last turn. I didn't have the global.
What is that? What is that for?
That is retaliating strike.
Learn to turn your opponent's aggression back when you deal damage with a force attack or melee. If you took damage since the start of the last turn, you deal an extra d6 damage. The damage is the same. Okay.
It's a DA at 9th level, though.
Oh. Why does it say that?
He probably didn't update it.
There we
Damn!
Go.
Damn! Holy Jesus. Shit. Don't fuck with Keel.
For real.
I will tell you right now, they are not happy, but at the same time, they're not really crying about it.
I'm Jim.
They're Mandalorians.
They're
Mandos.
They're going to go down not crying about it.
Big fat.
All right. It's Z's turn then.
Okay. Can I bonus action dash up and over the wall? Are you going to make me do
you
a...
Can, you can just climb the wall, but you'll just need to make an acrobatics check.
Okay. I'm
gonna... you didn't have me make an acrobatics check to climb it.
Make me an acrobatics check.
Yeah, I climb the
wall. I mean, you I'm already the on the other side of the wall, babe. I forgot to roll that. Sorry. Here you go. You get a
red
card this
far back. Rewind all of that real quick. No, I'm kidding.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm kidding. You didn't do anything anyway.
Yeah, I did. I missed.
You missed.
Okay,
I tried. Obviously, the repulsor wall hit me while I was throwing my lightsaber, and it fucked up my aim.
Obviously.
If I jump Obviously. Down off the wall, is that the same acro check?
Nope. It's just a jump down.
Okay, cool.
Keep in mind, you do take fall damage.
Not for 10 feet.
Really?
I'm
going to
go back here behind Quiet.
Pathfinder's
so,
different.
Ryko, whenever you're ready for flanking damage, if that's
Oh, yeah. Flavor. Let's go.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I take...
She might disengage, though.
She can try. I still get to hit her anyway.
Since am I behind her, can I do sneak attack?
No, you do not get sneak attack.
Okay. He's, I don't count for flanking.
You do not count for flanking.
I use my chakram on Quiet.
22 will hit.
That's 6 damage.
Huge.
That is 6 damage.
You
still have a bonus action.
I do.
Oh, you need to use your action or bonus action for Dizzy to fire.
Okay,
it's bonus action to control Dizzy.
If Dizzy's to come out of cover, can he see anybody?
At the moment, no. Everyone is below the wall.
That's what I thought. That's okay.
You can disengage as a bonus action.
No, I want to get that. I want to get that flanking damage.
Okay.
I'm gonna move on my turn probably.
Yeah, I will stay there.
I'm so glad.
fuck.
Okay. It is Threg's turn.
Hey, bud.
I'd love to see how he has close combat. He might just shoot at somebody else.
Nah, he's just gonna go ahead and move away.
Coward.
So you may make an attack of opportunity.
I'm gonna hit him.
Hit him.
I really gotta teach you these slow that levels thing.
One damage.
Yep. Well, hold on. The 2 is a 3, so that's 12.
What I have learned is I am Threg's worst 13. Problem. He's gonna disengage.
13 damage. Hold on.
Also, cool. is he concentrating on something?
No, he's not concentrating on anything.
Okay, that's good.
He's gonna go ahead and immediately spin around and do the exact same thing he did last round.
Sure.
Oh god, who does he want to hit?
Oh no, that was my reaction.
Yeah, it was.
Nah, it's fine. It's fine. I'm chilling.
So I would have disadvantage on hitting you. I could hit Daito, or I could just keep shooting at Keel because it's funny.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I think I'll shoot at Keel because it's funny.
Uh-huh.
All right, so he will make this attack at advantage because he's taking aim. Kablam. Nope.
Sir.
Second it.
There you go.
There it is.
I literally look at him. I'm like, what? You've missed. Ow. Okay, there it is. Thank you.
We're right between the eyes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, boy. 37, 44,
49. Ooh.
Thread,
I would go
dude.
Down, but I don't. What?
Okay.
Battle
is
card.
It a con save? Or nope. Is it just you go?
I get one freebie. Save? Yep.
Okay, cool. Now
well,
the
that changes my turn.
Now here's the thing. Do you yield because you did drop to zero?
No.
Okay.
Who do you think I am, Cypher?
I'm just checking. Quiet goes.
Fuck.
Fuck this shit, I'm out. Mm-mm.
Yeah, for real. I should have disengaged.
I will take an attack of opportunity if she's disengaging.
No, I just wanted to see something. Nah, because she knows your bullshit.
Has she seen me fight?
Yeah, she watched you and Keel fight in the cargo hold.
I did not fight with my lightsaber in the cargo hold.
That's a fair
technically
point.
I didn't either.
Technically you're not now, aren't you? Fighting with your knucklers?
Yep. So this is exactly what they saw in the cargo hold.
Well, let's see. Nope, she doesn't need to move, actually.
Fuck.
Specifically, she's going to use an ability that she has called Split Them Off. You are 15 feet away.
Who, me?
Yep.
From Z.
Oh,
that's good.
So she gets this at advantage.
Well, good luck, Z. Hey, Chad's here.
Whoa,
Chad, we're fighting our allies as a training montage.
I'm very sorry.
No, he's
not.
Yo, get Akron really... in here.
Okay, first things first.
Michael's gonna just die laughing.
First things first, I need you to roll me a constitution saving throw.
Please don't fail this.
DC is 14.
Whoa.
Let's go. That was
very,
huge.
Very good. That is very important. because
die.
Her weapons are poisoned.
This is supposed to be not.
It doesn't
lethal.
Matter. He's immune to poison.
But he's not immune to poison damage.
True.
So it will only be her base damage. Good for you.
Okay.
This is an additional 2d4 for the poison. And okay. She has an ability where the first time she attacks a target, she gets an additional 2d6.
Holy shit.
She is an assassin.
Hey, Z, remember when I told you to not fight Quiet because she kicked your ass?
So that'll be 22 damage.
Yep, I'm there.
I also need you to make me a
Holy shit!
Another Constitution saving throw.
God damn it! Okay.
You passed.
Hey, let's go.
You are not shocked.
Good. I mean, I am. Z is not.
Okay. So on that note, she is going to try and run.
I would like to take an attack of opportunity.
You may make an attack of opportunity. That will miss.
Damn.
As she goes, she does. What does she want to do here?
Yeah, this is the first time I think she's seen my lightsaber on, even.
And she's going to come over here to Daito. Why is the whole map moving?
It's not moving for us.
It's You're, moving for me, and I can't stop it.
Are you on the map layer?
No. Very strange. I hate it. Okay. That's the end of her turn.
Newbie
is going to go ahead and... What the fuck is wrong with this thing? Stop it.
He says that in character, by the way.
Dude's just yelling at his gun or something.
Daito.
Yes, sir.
He's going to shoot at you with his blaster rifle. You're not sure why, but he has advantage against you.
Okay.
Just everyone on this team has advantage.
There's a reason he has it, though.
Watch, they have fucking pack tactics or some shit.
They do not.
Two hits.
Okay, the first one.
Yep.
And the second one, he will add 2d6 to that.
Maybe Quiet like gives that to them by standing next to somebody.
So that is 15, 22.
Cypher just searched 22. For the word advantage in the monster manual and just like put all of the NPCs on a team.
I did no such thing. I actually made up all of these rules on the spot. Jokes. I actually thought about these. But as soon as he's done firing, he's going to go ahead and run up on Daito as well.
Of course.
Okay.
Even done any-
At the top of the initiative.
Ooh, this is a round. Is the level going to change?
Where are you? The entire map begins to shift as all the hexagons drop down and rearrange themselves into an entirely new map.
Interesting. Okay.
Damn.
All right. On that note.
How tall am I? 10 feet?
You're still 10 feet, but you are on the repulsor field.
Does that shove me off then?
It will shove you off.
Okay.
So you will fall over here. Daito, it is your turn.
All right.
So,
Look at the newbie.
1 second. I'm going to... can you see Chad?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I was going to pull your token on if you couldn't.
I'm good.
Okay. Daito, you're up.
Okay.
I'm going to look at the newbie that just
appeared to me. And I'd be like, the hell?
And she's just going to give you a little, like, finger wiggle, like a wave.
Okay, she's definitely the flirty one of the of
best,
the three
Beskar agents. Staff.
Beskar staff,
breaking
it is.
It out. Let's go.
On a crit, double dice and take
double
max.
Dice, take max damage.
Damn.
Did I swing for the head? By the way.
Bong.
Go ahead. So what are? Oh boy. So it's a D8. Plus a d8 plus 2d6, so that's 16 plus 12. So that's 28 already, plus an additional 6. So that's 34 damage?
Mm-hmm.
As that spear comes swinging down, you hit her square in the head, and she actually is knocked out.
Yeah. And I wiggle my finger back at her.
Amazing.
He's literally Master Oogway over here. Like, no.
So as soon as she is knocked out, the hexagons underneath her swallow her up. So she is removed from the field.
Dude, it's literally the D&B movie.
All right.
Except those people die.
You still got bullshit. Keep going.
Yeah, so now we're going to break it out on this one.
Please crit again. It'd be so good.
Yo, that would be amazing.
How?
Not quite.
Still good.
18 hits. 18 hits.
Pow.
Huge.
Damn!
13 damage. That is not to be trifled with.
Okay.
Okay.
And now, it's going to do some martial arts.
All right.
Bullshit.
Now remember, you can either choose to martial arts fists, or you can use your weapon again.
I was going to do fists, because I kind of want to see if I were to roll on that one.
Oh,
because
of
funny.
Keep in mind, in order for you to do that, you would need the long rest just like Dizzy does. So you do not have that at the moment.
Oh, okay, true, okay.
You do not have that at the moment.
That's okay, well, I'll still just do the martial arts then, but that's...
Okay, 27 hits.
Okay, pow.
13 damage.
And let's burn Senor Key Point. And Flurry of Blows. Let's do another 2 attacks. Yeah.
Okay, both of those will also hit. Roll your damage.
Pow.
Yikes. Okay. Anything else?
That's me. I'm good.
It is Dizzy's turn.
Yeah, he's just...
He's gonna chill?
Yep, he's chilling.
Yeah, smart.
Alright. Then it is Avo's turn. Oh, boy. This is not going the way I was hoping it would go. She's gonna go ahead and try to hit Z. I need you to, I just make a ranged attack. So that's 1d20 plus 6.
Sorry, I missed. Did you say that was on me?
That is
for
you.
He's rolling to hit you, yeah.
I am rolling to hit you now.
Thank you.
That is a failure.
Interesting.
That one.
Does she shock herself?
No.
Yes.
But then she'll just go ahead, like, after she misses, she's just gonna swing around and hand cannon, Keel.
Yep.
Jesus.
Yep.
Awesome. Wait, what? I thought your AC was higher than that.
Nope.
Yeah, but he used his reaction already.
I used my reaction to hit instead of my AC going up, because I'm an idiot.
Fuck!
Which means I'm out. So, doesn't matter what damage it is.
You are out.
Yep.
So, as soon as you hit the ground, you black out unconscious. And it swallows you whole as well.
Yep.
I was gonna heal you literally on my turn!
Fuck.
Ava will then go ahead and swing around and get behind the cover. It is Ryko's turn.
Can I see Ava from that point?
Yeah, you can. She will have half cover.
What about from this point?
Quarter cover. You can still hit her though, no problem.
And I don't provoke from him because I'm still in his threatened area.
Yes, that is correct. All right, make a hit.
Fuck.
That does not hit.
I am so over these shit rolls. That was a 3. I'm done.
Okay.
Bonus action.
Keel is out of the turn order. Z.
Did you hear me?
I did.
I have done nothing this whole bad.
Z, it is your turn.
Oof.
No. Who are you attacking anyway?
The green guy.
The green guy? Okay. Yeah, that will miss. And then you back up. Anything else you'd like to do? Bonus action, maybe shoot the big cannon?
He's in a meeting.
I know, that's why I'm typing it.
Okay, well, unfortunately that also misses. It is Rig's turn. He's gonna come around. And just because Ryko was giving him shit, he's gonna shoot at her. Pop a shot, but he is not kneeling. So these are straight rolls.
Miss.
All right, and
flip him off.
You. But he's actually gonna run up on Z now. But that's the end of his turn. Quiet is out of the combat.
Sorry, were those attacks again? Were those against me?
Nope.
No, they were against me.
No, they were against Ryko.
Thank you.
I was ready to deflection that.
I know.
Not like it matters, because I'm gonna roll a fucking one on that too.
Honestly, I'm so glad you both are standing where you are. As this guy immediately pulls out a giant vibro sword,
and so bring it.
And he looks at both of you and says, "I've been waiting for this. I wanted to do this for months." And he is going to swing twice at both of you. So for Daito, and these are at advantage.
Okay.
There's a 17 hit.
The 17 meets it, but I got some monk bullshit here that I'm going to use to...
Monk bullshit away.
Where is it? Patient defense? Got that one. Hold on. There's something here.
Is it the one where you...
You got your parry thing.
Yeah, agile parry. That's it.
Agile parry. Okay. If you make an unarmed strike as part of your attack action on your turn, holding your shiny weapon... Yep, so plus 2 to your AC, so that should make your AC, what, 19?
Yep.
Cool. So you'll only take 1 plus an additional D6, so okay. 7 damage. He will swing twice at Ryko. 22. Okay. And 24.
Okay.
So that is going to be 5, and another 5, and a D6. So 16. That is the end of his turn. Daito.
Yes.
As you're about to go, Cassis goes ahead and just says, "I'm bored. Do it again." As the map
fuck you,
changes
Cassis.
Once again.
Oh, Jesus. Okay.
At least no one was underneath the squares this time. What are these colorful areas?
That's a good question. You want to go find out?
No. Can I tell by looking at it?
You, from a brief distance, you know those are probably not fun to be around.
Okay.
Okay. It is Daito's turn. Proceed.
Vesper staff, go! Yeah.
15 will miss.
Hey,
Wait.
It's not flanking?
Crox, you should move up 10 feet, and then you can get flanking and advantage.
Yeah, you have to. You have to be...
Definitely do that.
There you go.
Wow, 29, that'll hit.
Nice.
Roll your damage.
Amazing.
Freaking love this guy.
Yeah. So as this dude is like flailing in like a frenzy, just wailing on both of you, you dive as Ryko is getting hit, and you just smack him on the back of the head as he like falls forward, and he's just gone.
How?
It is still your turn. You have made one attack.
Okay. Let's go. What's that? 10 feet, so I got. Let's go after this guy.
All right. The reg it is. Whack him.
Let's go. Go for the home run here.
This is where he gets another crit.
That would be hilarious.
I was about to fucking cry. 16 will not hit.
Damn. Okay, I'm gonna burn another key point.
All right.
And Furia blows that shit. And we'll use the Beskar staff too. So,
yo, let's fucking go! So many crits.
So that's 32 additional damage.
The actual crit machine.
Yup. 8, 16, 12, 28, plus 6. Yeah, nope, I'm sorry. That's 34 additional damage.
Fuck, that hurts.
I love this staff, by the way. Thank you.
Nice staff, sir.
I feel like Craig was just like, fuck, that hurts.
Yeah, no, straight up. Just to give you an idea, as soon as you hit it, that sonic damage rings through his armor. It does actually hurt. Anything else?
I'm a good. That's movement, is, action, bonus action. Dunphy.
It's these. It's Dizzy's turn.
He's gonna come right behind Z. He's gonna use medic.
Oh, that's right. You do have that. Okay.
Yep.
You can restore 1d4.
Plus 1.
1d4 plus 1.
So 3.
Yeah,
cool.
3
Love
HP.
It. Love it. And that's my action.
Okay. It's Avo's turn. What the hell is going on with this computer?
It's rebelling.
It is rebelling. I hate this. Oh, God. Okay. Do I want to do that? But I won't do that. You know what? Fuck it. She's going to try and hit Ryko with another wire toe. Nope. Oh, sad. She'll just take a hand cannon shot then. Kablam.
Who are you doing that on? Sorry?
To Ryko.
Copy that.
22. I will deflection. Damn. I needed to roll a 4.
Damn. 10.
Okay.
That is the end of her turn. It is your turn, actually.
Can you mute yourself for a second? Thank you. Ryko is fucking pissed. She's missed so many attacks, and she just watched Avo knock out Keel. So I'm gonna upcast this actually to 4th level.
Oh boy.
And she's gonna do something no one has ever seen her do. Hold on, I gotta check off 5 force points. Against Avo.
Yep.
Please make a constitution saving throw. DC 17.
DC is 17. She fails.
You take 30 damage and you're restrained.
So as everybody can see this, Ryko reaches out and like just kind of gripping the air, and immediately Avo begins like reaching for her neck and like clawing at her helmet as she gets lifted slightly into the air and begins to choke to like slightly to death.
Non-lethally.
Yeah, we'll see. Okay, as a bonus action, while the target is restrained, you can move them up to 5 feet in any direction. Do you wish to do so?
Yeah, I'm gonna drag her 5 feet towards me.
5 feet towards you it is.
Cool. I will bonus action defensive stance.
Okay. You know, I'm surprised Force Choke is not a concentration. Weird. Okay. Z, you're up.
Okay. So first things first, I'm going to get the fuck out of Dizzy's way really quick here.
Okay.
And now I have flanking damage, so I'm going to get sneak attack.
Yep. Well, you had flanking anyway.
Oh yeah, I guess that's true.
Because or you get sneak attack, now you have flanking.
Yep.
Go ahead.
So chained dagger on Thraig.
Roll your second attack just to make sure that you don't get a nat 20.
You want me to roll a second attack?
Yeah, because you have advantage. So see if you roll a natural 20.
Roll a crit. Yeah, I see. You're crit fishing now.
You do not. Okay, so you do 26 damage as you shiv this man in the back.
Is he dead?
No. He looks very pissed.
Okay, well, I'm going to use my railgun.
7 will miss.
Yeah, I figured.
That's okay. You got one good hit off with it.
And I bonus action disengage. Oh no, I've already bonus action. Right, dang it! Drake is pissed.
Drake is a little mad.
I feel like Z just snuck up behind him and stabbed him in the kidney real quick.
So Thrag is going to drop his gun, reach behind him, and pull out a vibro sword and immediately swing at Z. He has 3 attacks with the vibro sword. So the first attack,
miss.
Second attack,
it.
Third attack,
it.
He adds an additional D8 to these. God, keep that in mind.
Oh, Jesus.
He hit pretty hard.
So
that's 31.
Really hurting.
But that is the end of his turn.
Okay, thank God.
This guy is out. It is Daito's turn.
Daito, please.
Alrighty.
You can do this. I believe in you.
Staff, go.
That hits.
That was almost a crit again, I'd like to point out.
That wounds. He's still alive.
I feel like Thrag's the tankiest out of all of them.
That hits.
Pow!
And that immediately knocks him on his knees. As he is knocked out.
Z, push him over.
All right, anything else you'd like to do? There is still one fighter on the field.
Who is restrained?
I think it's only for that turn.
The end of her next turn.
Yep. Oh, end of her next turn? Aye. Gross.
Okay.
I mean, you say gross. If it wasn't for that, it'd be kind of a dumb attack.
Spell. Yeah, true.
That you hit. Auto, does he auto-crit because she's restrained?
No, he has, restrained, I think, is just you don't have any move speed.
Key point, flurry of blows. Ka!
All hit. This woman is choking on nothing as Daito comes around and proceeds to pummel her body like a punching bag.
Raiko smiles.
Also gives advantage, by the way.
Either way, it doesn't matter. He hit all of them.
There were no crits.
I know, but for the sake of edification of the group.
Yeah.
Very well. I understand.
I'm sure it'll come up
again. I also didn't know what the difference was. I never remember what the fucking difference was.
Oh, I'm thinking of grappled.
Yeah, grappled and restrained. I always think, why are these different?
Restrained is like worse than grappled.
And paralyzed like is like the worst.
Paralyzed sucks ass.
I should do stun more often.
All right, but for the sake of that, she is also down.
I'm still holding her, though.
I'm aware. Daito has not stopped punching. I'm making death saves now.
Oh.
Hey, guys, that was easy.
So she went down after the first attack, so she makes 2 death saves.
Oh, shit.
1 failure and
please
almost a crit fail.
Please don't roll an out.
1 success. Okay.
Panic. Just get me up and I'll get her up. It's fine.
Do you release?
It's not my turn.
Well,
you can release
as of right now, she's unconscious.
Well, it's not concentration.
It is not concentration. Oh, that's right. Okay. So then,
it
is
just
anybody
goes.
Else going to keep attacking? Or are you going to... You good?
I want to do something.
Okay. Then on that note, is Dizzy doing anything?
I mean, I guess for the sake of spice, like, he goes up and does medic.
Okay, D4 plus 1.
Oh, is she going to roll another save on her turn?
Yeah.
Oh, there's a chance she could roll a nat 1.
There is a chance she could roll a nat 1.
What the fuck? I mean, technically, she should be dead already.
She should be, but because she's an NPC, I'm giving them chances.
Oh, no, even if with death save, she should be dead already.
Why?
It was two punches, right?
Yeah, that's
That's right. It's two automatic failures.
Correct.
No, it's two automatic crits for melee.
Yep.
With each crit, which are two failures. That's four failures.
Yeah. Oh.
Yep. Oh, yeah, then Avo's dead.
No, don't do that. Shut up, so Chad. Hard.
Did I hit her too hard?
Dude, I want to point out Daito killed her, not me.
I literally punched her into the ground.
Yeah, literally Daito's beating a dead horse is the best way to put it.
Is it my turn?
Well, at the end of her turn, she does drop. And, like, she is lifeless.
They should have started shit with us.
No, it's the end of Raiko's turn.
Oh, it's the end of Raiko's turn? Yep. Okay.
I let go of her. Can I let go of her?
Technically, the answer is no, but I'm going to say yes.
She heals for 50.
All right, I'll allow it. I like my NPCs. I don't want to kill them.
I like my NPCs, too.
I'll just get her up. Get me up.
Well, nah, you're in the ground.
I took it to say it was non-lethal damage.
I was going to say, if we're out of initiative, I can
go. It's all non-lethal. I just for funsies, it's like him just continuing to punch her after she's knocked out.
Definitely accidentally killed Ava.
Oh, she's already dead.
She's already dead.
Didn't see that in your visions, did you, Daito?
Not this time.
All right, but as soon as you heal her, the ground will actually swallow her up as well. And immediately, all of the tiles sink back into the floor. The simulation ends, and you just see Cassis up top just clapping slowly like, well done.
Dude, Raiko just looks pissed.
And then he'll look at some of his subordinates and be like, go tend to the wounded, as they rush off immediately.
Where are the wounded, Cassis?
They are in the medical bay underneath the stage. So, in that note, Keel.
Hi.
You wake up. And someone is standing above your body, and they just injected something into you.
Yeah.
And he pats you. It's just a guy, and he just pats you on the shoulder, going, "Welcome back."
Okay, thanks.
I think, yeah, you were the only one who got knocked out.
Yep.
But like, all the others are there, and they're like starting to wake up as well.
I would like to point out, I feel like Avo looks particularly fucked, especially in the form of bruises around her throat.
Yeah, as she's swallowed up, Keel sees this as they begin to remove her armor, and she has massive contusions all over her body.
The fuck happened to her?
They don't even recognize your question as they're quickly trying to get her back. After a few moments, she does.
Can
take
I
a
get
deep
up
breath.
And go over to her?
Sure. She's not dead. She's just very badly beaten.
Yeah. Give life.
Okay. Yeah. As soon as you do that, like, she takes a deep breath. Her eyes, like, open really quick, and they're bloodshot. And she, like, breathes heavily, but then immediately, like, passes back out. Still breathing, but alive.
Yeah, she'll live. I think. Yeah, she'll live.
But yeah, Cassis walks back in, like, into the wall as the balcony closes up. You guys are led downstairs into the infirmary area where you do see Keel and the others being treated for their wounds. And
I'm like counting bodies down here, and I'm like,
we're all down there.
Yeah, you're all allowed to go immediately.
Cool.
Oh,
right,
yeah, we won. Sick. I was in character.
Yeah. Are you okay?
Shrugs.
I've never seen you get knocked out like that before.
That was rough. Honestly,
I was literally about to give you some healing, and then the floor swallowed you up before.
No, I did my job, I think. Which was save Z. You're welcome.
I might have gotten a little mad.
Z walks in a little?
It was a competition.
obviously it got to my head a little. It's fine. She's fine.
Yeah, Thrag, actually, as soon as he comes to and sees what's going on with Avo, he, like, gets up immediately and runs over to her. And he, like, kneels next to her and is just like, don't worry, it's okay, they're gonna take care of you. And then he, like, looks over at the party. What happened?
It's a competition.
Dude, I would like to say, out of character, I feel fucking bad.
I know.
In character, like, Raiko didn't do the final hits on her. She was still awake when I... She was still awake when I choked her, okay?
She was still awake when I choked her. Did you say that out loud?
Yeah.
He's just gonna look at you and take his helmet off and be like, okay. And he's just gonna take a deep breath and, like, look down at her, like, brush her hair, give her a kiss on the forehead, and then just be like, I need a minute. And he's just gonna walk out of the room.
I feel like Raiko's just, like, deadpan.
But,
I'm gonna sit there and pump just more give life into her.
Yeah, I mean, she's... They've got her on an IV drip. Like, she's regaining health very
quickly. Yeah. Like, but I want immediate results.
However, this is when something else happens. When the guy you guys didn't know kind of, like, takes a deep breath, rips his helmet off, and looks at the party and says, fuck you guys.
Fuck you.
As you recognize the face.
Huh?
It's the kid from the first mission. The one you killed.
We didn't kill him. Keel killed him.
Keel, I'm like, wow, dude.
Hey, wait. Wait.
The Mandalorians grab him and strap him down because he is, like, flailing trying to get at you guys.
Wait, you look familiar.
I should. You fucking killed me.
No, I didn't. You're alive. I look at, like, Raiko in the group and I'm like, did I kill him? I killed a lot of people.
You totally killed him. That was like your first kill.
Lean down to, like, where Keel is sitting on the bed and be like, yeah, you remember that kid from the mission with Zerka? Like, when
way
we first met?
A long time ago.
Yo, that annoying shit! Yo, hey, like, oh, look at him.
Yeah, I'm gonna see Raiko's just gonna be like,
dude, you're alive! What the hell?
He hisses and spits at you guys as he's, like, pulling away from these two Mandalorians who are, like, holding him down. And he's just like, fuck you guys. I'm gonna get you.
Did we kill a kid? I honestly don't remember.
I did.
Yeah, we did. Wasn't there, but, like, the other Mandalorian group that we ran into when we were scouting out the, like...
Drag was there?
Yeah, no, Drag was there.
ACOG wasn't there.
ACOG was not there.
Sorry. When the Mandalorians were shooting at us, Keel pulled the kid into the gunfire. And let him get shot to death.
Yep.
Yeah! We all knew that was gonna come back to bite us in the ass, or at least I did.
Nah, he was dead.
Is that who this new kid is?
He was still dead.
So, like, as this is going on, and he's, like, hissing at you guys, the door opens, and you see a Neo-Mandalorian in blue armor walk in. And he looks at the party, and then looks back at the kid, leans over him, and just goes, so you fucked it, huh? He just goes, fuck you, Nito. That's the guy that was working with Cal. The Mandalorian you guys let
shoot. So they gave
him
a chance to come kill us, basically.
Yeah, they revived him.
I thought he was dead.
Yep, and he just looked
at Look, kid, I didn't want you to die.
Keel's just like, smiling.
I just... Raiko's gonna, like, smack Keel on the back of the head, like... your face.
What? No, I'm actually surprised he's alive. Good job.
Yeah. Oh my god. Okay, you're not helping.
Nito will actually, like, push the kid's head down as, like, while he's straining, he does actually fall over, like, he's too weak to continue to fight. And he just walks over to you guys and goes, well, that was a waste of time.
Dido's gonna turn over to Keel and be like, hey, Keel, this is the second kill that hasn't died.
Don't you dare! Where's my fucking lightsaber?
I pushed Keel down on the bed. Calm down!
I'm fine!
No!
Let me heal Avo! Let me go!
She's fine! I healed her a bunch before they took her down.
That's the second time!
I mean, he's not wrong, though.
He's God, it's so funny.
That was amazing. You guys should have seen Cypher. I thought he was gonna fall over for a second laughing.
Yo, that's so funny. But yeah, as
I'm starting to doubt if Keel can actually kill anyone.
He kills undead real well, but they were already dead to begin with, so.
Listen, we all heard that that one dude was actually dead. We got proof. You can't hold me for that one.
But yeah, they're going to go ahead and give everybody some medical treatment. Avo is stable. Bruised, but stable. But, yeah, as soon as everybody is fit enough to go, the medics will go ahead and release them. And Nito will actually look at the rest of you and just be like, I've been called to bring you to the bridge.
Again?
Come on.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Round two.
I don't know why. Round two, fight. But yeah, as you guys get to the bridge, you see... Cassis sitting in a throne, like our hands, like pompous. Fingers interlocked, one leg over the other, leaning against the chair. Yes.
Before we leave the med bay, Raiko's gonna put her lightsaber like on Raiko's, or Raiko's gonna put her lightsaber on Avo's bed.
Okay. Is there a reason, or just because?
She feels a little bad. She's just not gonna say it out loud.
Okay.
Is that a threat?
Like... Oh, that's a, I'm sorry.
But yeah, you guys get to the bridge, and Cassis is sitting there, and as you walk in, he once again begins to clap that slow clap as he goes, well done, Mandalore did choose a couple of fine instruments for this army. I am surprised, to say the least. Very good. In that case, I have missions for all of you once you are back to fighting spirits. I will give you a little time to recuperate. Raiko Keel, I believe I have given you your assignment already. As of tomorrow, you're on mission.
Sounds good.
Okay.
Z.
What's up?
See me in 3 days. I have something special for you.
Gives a thumbs up.
Daito, I will call upon you when necessary.
Okay.
ACOG. See me tomorrow. I have something very interesting to talk about. Wait, where were you anyway?
Snoozing.
ACOG just takes a long drink.
He's just holding a bottle in here. I expect nothing less.
Gives zero shits. Amazing.
Yeah, like as he's swinging, Nito will reach over and take the bottle from him.
I feel like ACOG would just be like, I'm drinking that.
Excuse me, that's mine. Cassis will just be like, just sigh and just be like, see me tomorrow. I have an important mission for you and you alone.
Can I bring a friend?
What friend?
I don't know.
Quiet.
Obviously quiet.
Probably quiet, yeah.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Very well. That is fine. For the rest of the time being, everyone, go, rest, relax. You've earned it. I have enjoyed this training set.
Thank you, sir.
And with that, you will all get a long rest. No level up, just a long rest.
Well, yeah, it's just training.
It was just for funsies. And then,
I really needed that long rest.
Yeah, I know you did. Oh, to give you clarification, Chad, we did a slight shopping episode. Everybody, I made a mistake. I forgot to do this, but everybody was paid 25,000 credits.
Oh, hell yeah.
So you may purchase items.
Wait, was I paid 25,000 credits?
Yes.
Everyone was paid this money.
Okay.
So you have that
I
much money.
I just wanted to specify with you.
I'm aware. Everyone has that money to spend amongst any random objects, items, and enhanced items. As I have told the party, some enhanced items are easily accessible, others not so much. If they are military items, they're easily purchased. However, the cost varies depending on what item rarity it is. And you and I can go over that over the next couple of days out of game. Other than that, for the time being, the session is done unless you guys want to do anything else.
I'm good.
Okay.
I feel like I've done enough.
We get to RP that over the next week now.
Oh boy, yes we do.
So Crox, I think you and I have ours on Friday.
Yeah, we do.
Chad, you and I can get together tomorrow, probably right? not tomorrow. I have dinner with a family get together and my cousin from out of town who I haven't seen in like 3 years this year. Let's try and work on either Thursday or are you free Saturday?
Tanner. No, I'm not free on Saturday. We're doing dinner with Tanner. And
what about Sunday?
I could do Sunday.
Thursday.
Or Thursday, yeah.
All right. If I can get everything put together for you, I will let you know tomorrow if we can do it on Thursday.
Sounds good.
All right. Other than that, Mandalorians are bastards. That is all.
I'm sad. I didn't get to hit Thrag even once.
You did not.
I'm sad.
I almost feel like that was by design.
No, it wasn't, actually.
I was actually going to hit him, and then Keel got knocked really hard, so I was going to heal Keel.
I got hit hard twice.
Then Avo hit Keel down, and the floor swallowed him, and Raiko got a little pissed.
That was not by design. I mean, it was technically by design. I wasn't doing that to stop you, but like once you went down, it was, you're done.
Oh, I know.
Okay.
I'm fully aware.
So, at this point, any items that you guys purchased that require attunement or to be fixed on an item, for instance, the vocoder for Dizzy, these items are now equipped for the remainder of the game.
Yes. Dizzy has a vocoder now?
A 10 language vocoder.
Yeah,
does that mean
like
he can
a really
talk?
Nice one. Yeah, he can talk. Yeah.
He can talk
and
speak 10
languages.
I'm
not the only one that can understand him.
Yeah.
Correct.
Technically, you weren't before either. Threg also speaks binary.
Correct.
Whatever.
Threg also speaks binary.
Question.
Answer.
Next session will be the 4 month time skip.
Next session will be the 4 month time skip.
So I will have my cloak then.
You will have your cloak by that point.
Sick.
Keel, you will also have your focus and chassis available at that point. And everybody else's items, he got a chassis and a focus.
Mm-hmm.
And anybody else's items that have been procured that required a time limit will also be available.
I have a question. More specifically about my hour time on the time skip.
Yes.
For our runs that we do every so often, do we come back to the Dreadnought for those, or are we staying out for the 4 months doing that over and over?
You do back and forths for the most part. There are a few where you will be out there for a longer period before coming back to the Dreadnought.
Okay.
But most of the time, it's out and back.
Okay. That's what I thought.
I have a similar question.
I have a similar answer.
Am I in the same boat where I go back and forth, or am I actually staying there?
So you will be staying
on the planet below
that we discussed.
Yep.
For weeks at a time. You will be able to return, but you will be down there for 2 to 3 weeks at a time.
Okay. So like 3 weeks on, 1 week off, 1 week of leave type thing?
Pretty much, yeah.
Got it. Second question.
Second answer.
Can I get a premium vibroweapon chassis to build a hooked vibroblade?
Yes, you could. You know the rules.
Yep.